Greetings, everybody. Welcome to Spooky Weekend Board Game Fun. I am Dave. If you're here, then you've passed into the other realm. Ooh, spooky. Except not, because it's just normal Twitch, but with spooky things. We're going to do some tabletop simulator and a spooky game. The game being, I've got it here. Which one? This one. Betrayal at, oh, it's backwards. Betrayal at House on the Hill. Including the Widow's Walk expansion, which, if I'm there, please flicker the lights. What about, let's do this. Ooh. Yes, I can hear you. Hello. Yes, this is a board game that I do physically possess, as well as the expansion and bloomers. Send shivers down your spine. Hey bloomers.
Hey underscore bloomers just subscribed. Such spooks.
I will
button to press again so soon.
Button to press.
Press button.
Nice, yes. I can undeafen on Discord because Bloomers is here. Hi Bloomers.
Hello, I'm definitely not eating refrigerators.
That's fine. You could do that. But yes, Betrayal at House on the Hill. I feel like I've played this at least once online with you before. I was going to ask if you've played it before, but I think...
Me?
Have you?
I have not played this before, no.
No? Yeah, well.
Negative.
It's a fun game where you basically build up a haunted house. It's the classic scary movie setup. A group of people arrive at a scary house, and as they explore, they discover more and more creepy things. And then at some point, one of us is revealed to be,
turned into a baddie.
A ghost or a werewolf or something. In the original rulebook, there are, I think, 95 different...
Gosh. Scenarios. I know there's a couple of different versions now, isn't there?
Oh, no, there's
a new one with more scenarios, no?
There are 50 in the original, and then in the expansion of The Widow's Walk, which is a different book, there are another 50. Plus some extras, which you're meant to do in order, which is like the witch ones. Like the proper Widow's Walk things.
Because I saw Will Wheaton used to have a tabletop gaming channel a long while back, and
yes.
I remember him playing it.
Yeah, I think I saw him play it and then bought it afterwards. There's been a few board games I've got through that.
Yeah, there's definitely a few that I would be interested in playing because of that, and also there's a newer channel. I think they kind of came into being over lockdown originally, called No Rolls Barred. Mm-hmm. And they played it a little while back. I've sort of become aware of them more recently and watched some of their back catalogue, although their cast has changed ever so slightly. They've lost a member recently for reasons I will not go into. But yeah, they are fun. They're based in London. They played it with... I'm sure they played it on like a live stream, and someone was like... They got to control like demon cats or something. They turned into a monster and they had like a...
Yeah, that's about right. So you'd normally turn into some kind of evil and you then control other minions and that sort of thing, and you're trying to open a portal to hell, or... We've played it a few times and we always try and like get different things every time, you know, just in case. One time, a giant bird picked up the entire house...
Oh.
And then we were all against each other running around trying to find a limited number of parachutes so that we could escape. Another time we played, everybody was getting older, like every time something happened, or like per round. So someone who happened to be playing that one of the older characters to begin with just died of old age quite quickly, which is unfortunate.
Oh, but yeah, I think the other one, like you, the baddie didn't necessarily have to kill people, but like they had to set fire to the house or something, and if they set so many fires, they won.
There's many different scenarios. We're also joined by Andy Pants.
Woo! Hello.
Hi.
Definitely was not stuffing tacos into my face furiously for the last 5 minutes.
Nice.
tacos.
I think Trelawney is also going to join us. He's grabbing a drink. And then, yeah, I can show everybody the board if OBS picks it up. Hello. There we go. This is the spooky board. I found a version with scripted stuff so that you can do your stats. I've imported a few extra bits like mist and rain, and if I find the button, hang on, I put a box somewhere. If I do this,
oh my god, then there's lightning, a painting on the wall.
Lightning appears. That's I could turn these effects off because they might get annoying.
That's only on stream. We have fog in game, but we don't have rain or lightning.
Can you not see the rain?
No, that's only for stream.
Oh,
just fog.
Interesting. You might need
have
to.
Have you seen the painting on the wall?
Yes, I've seen the painting.
I don't like it.
There it is.
Hello,
Trelawney.
Hello.
So yeah, this I can turn the rain off and then turn it back on again. It's from a cube in the sky.
Sky cube.
Yeah, maybe that's not loading for you. Never mind.
Yeah, it's no load for me.
I think the mist is going to be too annoying, but I can do this and it just pulls it all away.
Vanishes.
Nice. So, yeah. This is the board. We start in this entrance hall, as you can see here, and then you pull rooms and place them places. So this is the entrance hall. You can't get out the front door in the foyer. The grand staircase goes up to the upper landing, and then the upper landing also goes up to the roof landing. The foyer also goes down to, maybe the staircase goes down to the basement. Maybe is it all on the stairs, or it might be one where you can't get to the basement until you've revealed something. It's been a while since I played this.
I feel like I've definitely seen one where someone got trapped in the basement because they got like teleported there by a card action, but then there weren't stairs to get up or something.
Yes, that's right. So the grand staircase and the upper landing link, and then the roof landing and the basement have to be discovered by cards. Right. It's like a coal chute and a collapsed room. A mystic elevator, stuff like that.
Cool.
So yeah, I mean, you can take a look at the characters, decide who you want to be. They each have two options. So if you click on the thing, you've got different states that you can swap to, or you can press, if you put the mouse on it and go 1 and 2. And then the yellow numbers are your starting stat, and then that can go up and down.
Right.
Depending on who you want to be. So.
So I'm currently 3, 4, 5, and 3.
Yes.
And then if I change to state 2, oh, they go away? No.
5, 5, 3, 3, and 4.
Oh, well, do I get to choose which I want?
Yes, you can be either of those characters, or you can be any of the other characters.
Oh, I can be Zoe Instagram.
Instagram. Ingstrom.
Or Missy Dubordy.
Dubois, I believe.
Oh, Dubois. Oh,
Dubord?
Dubois.
Who knows?
Lynn is saying it is very dark. In fact, everyone is saying it's very dark. And okay. Lynn is saying the rain is making it additionally...
Sure, that's fine. This is just like the... This is... We can just go back to this. And I can turn the rain off. There you go. It's fine. I was just going for atmosphere as we start. But... and then we turn it off. It's fine. Oh. I froze.
Oh, your brightness changes my brightness. I've seen people play it a couple times online, but I'm by no means have not played.
I have played this game one or a couple times about 8 years ago.
Hmm.
But I have not used tabletop sim, so if I'm clicking bad things and making horrible things happen, I'm sorry.
it's fine. It's mostly click and drag. You can like drag a box over the dice and pick them all up to roll them. And then there's a button that returns them to their spot. But yeah, I mean, choose a character. If you don't want to be either of these young boys, Andy Pants, you can click in the top right and change colour to be...
Ox Bellows.
Ox Bellows.
Right, let's go.
The Ox Bellows. Also, that I found little 3D models that someone has made. I think they've made them in Hero Forge and then put them in. So once you've picked your character, you can make them.
Oh, you can be Vivian Lopez or what's the other one? Oh. Madame Zostra. Ooh, she's a spooky lady.
Madame Zostra. Sure, I can turn Andy up a bit.
His stats and stuff, I can...
Okay. Yeah. Ox Bellows.
Yeah, so
wow,
you have...
You've got mutton chops.
You have starting stats, and then they can improve in different numbers. Like, Ox Bellows can get very strong.
Nice. Let's go.
But not as fast as other people.
Sure, that makes sense.
So yeah, I mean, in theory... Any of them are as good as any others until the haunt starts and we know what we're trying to do. And then maybe strength is more useful, or maybe intelligence is more useful.
Sure.
Nice. What's the little lantern?
So once you've chosen your character and you've switched, because it doesn't work when you switch states on your little person.
Yeah.
So if you're being Zoe, then in theory you should be able to drop it on this, and then you can make have a torch or stuff like that, or a candle. That might make it a little bit easier to see where your characters are.
Cool. Bullseye lantern. Dark vision. Ooh.
Yeah, so it's I think it's made for like D&D stuff, but
lantern hood up. Lantern hood down.
Off. Some the scripting sometimes goes a bit funny, but
looking at Ox Bellows' character model, he is a bit of a big lad.
He
isn't
is, yeah. Shall I look at it? Get the light.
Is he built like an ox?
Get multiple lights to work here. Let me go.
You could say that. Yeah, he's got lungs like a pair of bellows too. Big lad.
Do I want to be?
Is there
Father Reinhardt or Longfellow?
Technical question: is there a way? Because like I can see on stream, you can like move around the board. Mine seems to be stuck on the middle. Huh?
Oh,
yeah.
I gotcha.
You can also press P to switch between first person, top down, and third person.
But yeah, right click is your like pan tilt zoom. Well, sorry, pan tilt.
Yeah.
Scroll wheel is zoom, and then WASD is your walking
or
the camera.
If you have
around,
a middle mouse button, you can click that and drag it around.
Yeah.
Oh, neat. Okay, cool.
And then there's also, I can never remember which way around the hotkeys are, but where's the controls?
Yeah, you can set
save
you can set
cameras.
Places to look, can't you?
It's like one of them's Alt and one of them's Shift, so like Shift. Shift 1 is recall camera 1, so Alt 1 is Sorry, that's one of my streaming hotkeys. I won't. Let's not do that then. I won't save any cameras.
Amazing.
Good.
Yeah.
Nice.
It was the ghosts.
Yes. Okay. I think I shall be Father Reinhardt.
No.
Down here with his little torch and his cross.
Here he's got some pretty good looking goggles, glasses, spectacle.
Yes, yes, he has the spectacles. Right, so once we've got our characters, we all start in the entrance
hall. Have you worked out your little torch thing, Andy?
Not quite.
If you move your little lady...
Just pop her there.
Oh, Dave's doing it.
Press, and it's not got to be like there, right? There you go. And she can have a little glowy. Might help to find.
You can see where you are.
And then put her over here.
Yeah, we all start in the entrance hall. Like we've just rolled up to this spooky house. The classic combination of teenager, girl, priest, and jock. that's the classic. The classic.
Oh, can you not? Okay. Oh, I can't shuffle myself.
Classic setup.
I can flip myself though. Yeah.
Oh,
why? Why do you want to be on your head? Fabulous.
It amuses me.
Great.
I'm a simple creature.
So yeah, there are several. We obviously each have a turn, and on your turn there's several things you can do. You can move the number of squares that is your speed. So you start with your regular speed. Mine is 3, so I could move 3 spaces. You can discover a new room, which you can do after you've used all of your speed or at any point before. You can use an item or an omen card once you've picked up one of those. You can attempt a die roll, which will happen sometimes when the haunt starts, or sometimes in general rooms. Hi, Buddha. Or you can make an attack once the haunt starts, if there's something you need to attack. So, for the most part, we just start just opening up doors and...
Why is there a dice called Professor Longfellow?
Where?
It's like a big chunky D12 looking thing, but it's got coloured numbers on.
Oh, back here. That's if we need to pick someone randomly.
Oh, okay.
Which we don't need to do right now. Because according to the instructions, whichever character's birthday is next goes first. Mine is April the 29th.
How do I know this?
It says...
May 13th.
It says age, height, weight, hobbies.
Oh, damn.
Where it say this?
Round your person on your little character card.
Oh, it does! Oh, can we introduce ourselves?
Sure.
I am 8 years old.
Hello.
I am 3'9" tall.
Sounds about
I
right.
I weigh 49 pounds. I have no idea what that means.
No, no one does.
My hobbies are music and dolls, and my birthday is the 5th of November. That's bonfire night.
Wow, what that's... I mean, you're probably going first, because that's really close.
Yeah. Where can I see that?
You have to zoom right in on your roundy, roundy face, and it's written round your roundy face on your
roundy
card.
Roundy face. Oh, I see. Oh, he is a bit of a big lad, isn't he? Jesus.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, so I don't mind going next. So, I'm Ox Bellows, 23 years old, 6'4", 288 pounds in... old money, so I don't know what that is in real units.
That's heavy. That's heavy.
Yeah, it's pretty. It's a big ride.
Yeah.
And then hobbies: football, shiny objects.
Yes.
And birthday is October the 18th.
So we've just missed your birthday.
So sad. It's okay. So he just turned 23.
Yeah.
What a guy.
So, I guess my name is Jenny. I am 21. I am 5'1" and 142 pounds. My hobbies are reading and soccer, and my birthday is March 4th. Ooh, that's my brother's actual birthday.
Nice. I'm Father Reinhardt. I'm 62 years young. I'm 5'9" and 185 pounds. I enjoy fencing and gardening. And my birthday is in April. I guess I'm a sword fighter, as well as a priest.
Damn.
And here we all are.
Nice.
With our torches, crosses, pipes, Walkman and book, and Teddy. That's what we've got.
Amazing.
Nice. I didn't know we were meant to bring weapons, so I just like tore a bit of the guttering off.
Yeah.
My weapon is a teddy. I'm sure it's fine.
Nice. Well, Zoe, you are up first.
Cool.
So
what I do?
So no you role. Can you I'm can move sure. Why have you got double rings on your
I don't know. Sanity's got two rings, but the others have only got one. I have no idea.
Oh, I can't.
Oh, it won't let that's me... not how I see it. Mine looks like I've got two rings on my sanity, but all the others have one.
Oh, this needs to reset. I don't know how to do it. If I clone.
I promise I didn't mess with it.
I can make another one.
For a change, I didn't actually mess with anything.
Yeah. That's... I don't know why that's weird.
Yeah, the way you're seeing it is different to what I see as well. Because I've got little. Oh.
Can you have you any?
Whoa.
Can you move your rings up and down?
Yes, but some of them are changing numbers, or are they meant to be like that?
Yeah, so that's how you're tracking these stats. So.
Oh, okay. So if I move my sanity ring, one remains on the yellow number,
yeah.
And then the other one moves.
So. That's if I delete this, then you should be okay.
Yes, yeah. Now mine look okay.
Da.
Yes.
Move the one that doesn't. And then. There you go. And then, as long as it's starting on the yellow one, that's
yes.
Fine. Is yours working, Trelawney? You don't have the buttons.
I have no idea.
Have you not hit load stats yet?
Well, he had the rings, but.
Oh,
oh no,
yeah,
you can either.
I have it load stats.
Now the buttons are fine. Yeah. Cool. So yeah.
I only have one ring on.
Oh, you do only have one ring.
Where's load stats?
You should have already.
Is there something I need to
I think you've already done it. Can you only see one of your rings?
I can only see one of Andy's rings too.
I've only got this one.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there they go.
Oh, I can see two. Oh.
Oh, once you've hit the button, I guess you can see it. Sure.
Oh, okay.
Nice.
But Trelawney can see two now?
Yeah,
this
I can
game
see them
is...
all now. I can see them all. It's fine. Yeah, I
great.
Can only see two at the beginning.
It's fine. The scripting in tabletop servers interesting sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, there's.
Yeah.
It's one of the reasons we maybe don't use it for D&D anymore.
True.
Yeah.
It got a bit weird.
Oh, Brandon, he's sitting over here with rings on himself for some reason.
Yeah, he's just chilling. He's not here. He didn't come.
No.
To the thing.
No. Exactly.
So, Zoe, you can move up to four spaces.
Exciting.
So, you can open any. You can open a door on the ground floor, or you can go up a level and open a door there.
So, sure, let's go upstairs, I guess.
Sure, so that's one, two, three spaces.
Three, and then opening a door is my fourth, or
no, opening a door is separate, so that's
okay.
That's free. So you just end up going in there. So
I'm gonna open the west door.
Cool. So this is your tile.
The moon is north.
You can flip it over and
flip.
Attach it wherever you'd like.
Attic.
make the doors line up.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
So the attic, when exiting, you must attempt a speed roll of 3+.
Uh-oh.
If you fail, lose a might, but continue moving.
Why has it got a spinny circle in it?
And then like that symbol is an event. So...
Do I have to go in the door I opened?
Yes, opening a door is going into it. That's how it works. So if you hit the draw button on top of the event.
Draw, yes.
Tell us what happens to you.
Nothing happened.
Oh, maybe these... Oh, this might I think this is just... This isn't a button. Okay. This is just saying, this is the draw pile, and this is the discard pile.
Oh, I see.
I press draw. Oh, what?
Hang on, I can just deal one to you. There you go. Did that work? Deal to orange. It's not working. I'll just drag one over to the table.
Thanks.
There you go. That's easier.
I have it now.
Cool.
I do F for flip.
Yes.
Yeah. Lights out. Your flashlight goes out. Don't worry, someone else has batteries. Keep this card. You can move only one space each turn until you end in the same room as another explorer. At the end of that turn, discard this card, then you can move normally again. If you have the candle or end your turn in the furnace room, you can discard this card.
Okay, so you're just in the dark in the attic now.
Yeah, I can move one space, but I can't get out the attic without two movement, so I just live there now, right?
No, you can get out, but I think
you can go back onto the landing.
Yeah, but you need to make you need to make a speed roll.
Oh, right.
So you can
do
that.
Does my speed go down, or is it just a temporary?
No, so if you fail the speed roll, you lose might. But if you want to leave the attic now, then since you've still got a movement, you can.
Yeah. Okay. Is it worth leaving the attic to make it slightly easier for someone to reach me?
Actually, no. You moving into a room does count as a movement. But you can.
I have none.
But you can move your full movement and then go into a room.
Right. Okay. So I moved 3 and then went into a room. So that's all my movement.
That's your 4.
Now.
Yeah. So next turn you'll have to make a speed roll to get out.
If I want to get out.
I mean, there's no other doors in the attic, so you can't go anywhere else.
But someone might want to come visit me and give me my speed back.
Sure, but we don't know that you're in the dark.
That is true.
If someone comes upstairs, maybe they'll hear you shouting.
Yeah.
Other than that. right, Jenny, it is your turn.
My turn. Okay, so I can go up to 4 spaces.
So that's also going anywhere you like, because the board is currently small.
All right, so I will go. Let's see, what have we got? Can I go in the foyer and then go left?
Yeah, sure.
All right.
So, since you're opening a ground floor, I have to flip through here until we get a ground. Ah. There we go. That's a ground.
Yay.
So there's... You found the treehouse.
Right. Normal inside rooms.
Put a plant token on any open door on the roof or upper floor.
What?
This room is adjacent to that door. Might put it this way, so we've got more options.
Sure.
So we only have one other room, so it has to be the attic, right?
Yeah, so we'll put a plant token. There's also an event, so if you want to have a look at that event and read it out while I try and find a plant token. Is it here? No.
Freaking wind. The wind picks up a slow crescendo to a screeching howl. Each explorer in the gardens, graveyard, patio, tower, on the balcony, or in a room with an outside-facing window must attempt a might roll. That's not any of us, right?
I don't think there's any windows in the attic, and... There's none in here. Oh, you're in the treehouse.
How
now
are they
as well.
Depicted?
If you look on the grand staircase, you can see the windows there.
Right.
But there's. So yeah, that's a good time to have that event happen because none of us.
Yeah. So it is discarded.
Yeah, throw it in the discard pile.
Whoa.
I can't
get out of here.
This is an obstacle. Where are the? Where's the plant tokens? This.
I can't see them. There's monsters over by me, but they don't seem to be plants.
No.
We could use a tentacle in its place. They're quite plant-like.
Item pile. Numbered item tokens. Emergency items?
It says you've somehow deleted a copy of everything. But it also doesn't say what's in it.
Square tokens. This might be it. There we go. Plant token.
Ah.
So this plant is now linked to the treehouse.
Oh, the attic is.
Yeah.
I want a treehouse off my foyer. Actually, I want a foyer first.
So could I potentially go down the plant?
You'd still have to roll to get out of the attic, but
I could do that instead of...
Yes. Okay. You've still got two movement, Jenny, if you want, but you can't open another door. You'd have to go back to the foyer or up to the attic if you want.
I'm good. Well, okay.
Can we put another plant token in the treehouse so I can remember that's a thing that happens? Cluedo has the double-ended secret passages.
Plant.
Yeah. I can go up to the attic and get Zoe some extra batteries.
You could.
Yeah, is it ending your turn or ending...
Yes. Not the... Yeah.
Yeah, so Zoe has to end...
Hello, what is this plant? By the way, I need batteries.
Yeah, but Zoe has to end her turn in the same room as someone.
Oh.
So,
okay.
So, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I'll just stick with it.
Unless you'd have to spend your next turn just in the attic. But you can only move one space anyway, Zoe, so. Cool.
Yeah, I'll just stay here.
Sure. It's now Father Reinhardt's turn. He's just gonna walk through the door on his right. It's the collapsed room. Oh, okay.
Hello.
Attempt a speed roll of 5+ to avoid falling. If you fail the roll, draw a basement tile, put it in play. Fall there and take a die of damage. Okay. My speed is only 3. That's not ideal. So, a speed roll of 5+ is you roll the number of dice that is your speed, which is 3,
right.
And then the dice have 1, 2, and 0 on them.
Oh.
So 5 is kind of hard to get with 3 dice. Let's see how I do.
Hey!
That is exactly 5. Yeah. I do not fall.
Yeah, I mean,
good.
The fact that, it looked wonky, but the game said
The game
two,
decides
so.
What it is.
So. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Wonky's so,
I do count.
I just skirt around the edges of the collapsed room. There you go. That's my turn. Oxbellows.
All right. I think Oxbellows will open this door over here.
Sure. Another ground tile. The graveyard.
Ooh.
Okay. When exiting, you must attempt a sanity roll of 4+. If you fail, it's being rotated. if you fail, lose 1 knowledge, but continue moving.
Sure.
Okay, so opening a door puts you in there, doesn't it? So
yes, and then you get an event card.
Secret stairs.
Oh.
Secret stairs.
It's like Zelda. You push a gravestone and.
Yeah! Amazing. A horrible creaking sound echoes around you. You've discovered a secret stairway. Put one secret stairs token in this room and a second secret stairs token in an existing room on another floor. Ooh. Move from one secret stairs token to the other counts as moving one space. The stairs don't count as a space. You can follow the stairs right now, even if you don't have any movement left. If you do follow them this turn, draw an event card in the new room.
Okay, well, I mean, the only other room is the attic again.
Yeah,
so... leads to the attic.
The landings not count then?
What does it say? Like,
it says room, but I take it a landing isn't a room?
Existing room on another floor. Ooh, do the rules state anything about whether those count as rooms?
The landing is room S.
Yeah, because given we have a collapsed room, a stairway out of the basement in advance of someone falling down there.
No, I mean, it just says they're special rooms rather than rooms. So do you want to go, you could go up or down with the stairs then to the roof or to the basement?
Oh, sure. Let's open up the basement. Why not? This is Ox Bellows.
There you go.
He doesn't mind.
Are you following the stairs?
I think I will follow the stairs.
Nice.
Yeah.
Sure.
Does that count as exiting this room and therefore I have to make a sanity roll?
Yes, I believe so.
Right, my sanity isn't 100%, not gonna lie. Ox Bellows is a strong man. He's not a sane man necessarily. He's been through a lot. He's at the end of his tether.
Yeah.
Don't know why he's here. Yeah, so sanity roll, how many die do I roll?
So if your sanity's 3, you roll 3 die.
Got it. Is there a cool way of rolling these? Or
just swing wildly.
Like that. Yeah. Ox Bellows can do that.
Uh-oh.
2.
Oh no.
2. Oh no.
So there you go.
Use one knowledge.
So you have a ring.
Yeah. Ox Bellows forgets his birthday.
Yeah. So.
Oh no.
So yeah, it's things happen that make your stats go up and down. If your stat hits the skull at the bottom, you die.
Oh,
that's
nice.
right.
However, you can't die before the haunt has started, before one of us has become evil. So,
cool.
So you could lose knowledge and literally die of stupid.
Yes.
Let's go.
Forget how to breathe. You're that stupid.
Yeah. Nice. That sounds about right. Right, so I open up the basement.
Yes, and then you get another event card.
Oh.
Yeah.
The basement is an event?
Over by the basement.
Oh.
So
how did that happen?
That was the part of the secret stairs
event. Oh, the secret stairs. Oh, cool.
Yeah, I kicked over a gravestone and Zelda'd my way down.
Flip.
Nice.
Webs. Casually, you reach up to brush some webs aside. But they won't brush away. They cling. You must attempt a might roll. 4 plus. You break free. Gain 1 might and discard this card. 0 to 3. You're stuck. Keep this card. If you're stuck, you can't do anything until you're freed. Once during an explorer's turn, any explorer can attempt a might roll to free you. You can also attempt this roll. A 4 plus succeeds, but you don't gain the 1 might. Anyone failing an attempt can't move for the rest of their turn. For the rest of that turn.
Yeah.
After 3 unsuccessful attempts, you break free automatically on your next turn, and you take your turn normally. When you're free, discard this event.
I mean, luckily, Ox Bellows is pretty strong.
He's a big lad. Yeah, indeed, as we've established. So I get to roll 5 dice.
Yes.
Whoa.
Got to roll 4 on 5 dice, so probably okay.
Yeah, but you can't roll dice, though, right?
You can roll all zeros.
Yeah. Ox Bellows. Are the gods with you?
He's fine.
It would seem so. Yeah, nice.
There we go.
Total of 6. Do I gain 1 might?
You do gain a might. You're even stronger.
Ox Bellows is so strong.
Oh, I thought you had to get a 4 exactly to gain the might.
No, it's 4
plus.
It's
4 plus.
No, just need to beat it. Yeah.
Nice. So we're back.
Oh, he's a big lad.
We're back to Zoe. Nice.
I am in the dark with my teddy bear.
So you can roll to get out of the attic and then move one space. I'm guessing you probably want to climb down the plant.
I'm going to go down the plant, I think.
Get some batteries.
Because I shouted out and know that my mate, Jenny, who I assume is my role model because, like...
Yeah, maybe older sister, babysitter.
Maybe, responsible babysitter.
Yeah, I'm picturing babysitter who's dragged the kid out to a scary house with her boyfriend, Ox Bellows.
Yes, it's a mess.
And there's just a priest there for some reason.
And a random priest.
Yeah. And now we're all friends. Yeah, cool. So what do I roll to
Speed roll. So
okay, my speed is four. Okay. Ooh, my wazadding is a little... There we go. Chaotic.
I believe in you.
Thank you.
Oh, no!
Oh, no!
Your belief in me is misplaced!
So, you lose one might.
Oh.
Oh, no.
It remains a three, though, so that's fine. Not the worstest thing.
Sure.
Oh, I was hoping if I put the dice next to the dice, they would...
If you click the button, it returns them.
Yes. Oh-ho! Beautiful.
So yeah, you can climb down the plants.
It's Buzz. Boop, 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 boop. Hello! I went to the attic. It is not very fun up there.
So are you ending your turn to get batteries? I think in theory you could open a door, but then you'd be in the new room and you wouldn't end your turn.
Well, I couldn't because... Oh, yeah, that's true, because I've moved one, but if I can open a door without any movement, then I could open a door, but I think I'm probably better getting my movement back, right?
Yes. So, yeah,
cool.
If you end your turn, you can discard that card.
Yeah.
And then it's Jenny's turn.
Discard him? Yeah.
Alright, I am going to go... I'm going to go back through the foyer and open a door on the other side.
Sure. Another...
Get some more rooms.
Another ground. It's the laundry!
Oh, look, that lines up.
That's
perfect.
The scariest thing of all.
Oh, no!
What is that? Oh, it's a...
So this
was a uterus. It is
no. It's a skull. So
if you're zoomed out, it looks.
Yeah, it does.
I mean,
it totally
not looks... wrong.
I was like, what is this game? Okay.
So yes, this is the laundry. You get an item card, and there's also a dumbwaiter here.
Oh.
You can get in the dumbwaiter to travel to. Another place with a dumb waiter.
Which of yet we have not won?
Not yet, no.
Okay. What does the count?
Oh, hang on, it's you can move from that room to the landing, either up or down a floor.
Oh. Okay.
It takes a movement.
Oh, cool.
Hmm. What does the not uterus mean?
That's an item.
Oh. You get
an item, here you go.
An item.
Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh. An old map of the house. When you roll for your movement or to enter, exit, or cross a room, you may choose your result. You may travel between rooms that have a dumbwaiter.
Oh, nice.
Oh, that's powerful.
Pretty useful.
Sweet. So I keep that, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Awesome.
And then the laundry is, if you end your turn here, you can discard an item to draw an item from the discard pile. There's currently no items in the discard pile.
Yeah.
So, that's useless. You still have two movement, so you could exit the laundry if you wanted. Or you could use your blueprint.
You can't open any more doors, right?
No, you could use your blueprint to go to the basement landing or to the upper landing. For one movement.
I think I will stay here for the moment.
Sure.
Yes.
Okay, it's the professor's turn. I'm gonna just shimmy round the collapsed room and open.
Oh wow, this is a multi-purpose room.
Yeah.
Yes. The study.
Ooh, it's another omen.
Another dumbwaiter card and an omen card. Once per game, if you end your turn here, put your explorer token here and gain one mental trait, which is sanity and knowledge. So,
nice.
Nice.
So first, I get an omen card, which is the box. They were always telling you to think outside of it. Now you're worried you'll end up inside it. Ha 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 ha. When you draw this card, draw an item card and put it on this card. That item cannot be dropped or traded. If someone would steal that item, you can instead discard the box.
Oh.
On your turn, you may remove the item from the box and put a different item in the box. If it is empty, you may put an item in the box. The box cannot be stolen. So, in the box is a candle. It makes the shadows move. At least you hope it's doing that. Draw an event card. If you draw an event card, roll an additional die for the trait rolls. If you have the bell, book, and candle, gain two.
Ooh.
First time you lose one of those three items in the game, lose two from each trait.
Or
gain two in each trait, and then the first time you lose it again. Sure. And then a haunt roll. I forget how many. I think, is it all eight dice or is it less? Let me look it up. Six dice.
That's real powerful.
Every time someone picks up an omen, they have to make a haunt roll where you take three dice, and if you roll less than the total number of omens that have been drawn, the haunt starts. So basically,
so
it's
to roll zero.
Yes, so it's a way for the haunt to start, but it gets more and more likely the longer the game goes on. So it does not start now.
Nice.
So we carry on, and I'm ending my turn in the study, so I'm going to take a point in knowledge. Go up to five.
Knowledge.
And then I need one of my
tokens. What is your box made of? Because I feel like a lit candle.
It's not a lit candle. It's a box, and this isn't mine.
If it's an unlit candle, it's very clever at making shadows move.
Well, no, it's a box with a candle and a matchbox or whatever in it to light the candle.
Uh huh.
So I can have a lit candle whenever I want.
Sure.
Oh, I see. There's These haunt dice are... These six dice, grey dice here, are meant to be the haunt dice. I see. That makes sense. Great. So, Ox Bellows, it is your turn.
Eh?
You are in the basement.
Oh, the specific haunt dice.
Oh.
I assume it's set up... we can't hear you, Dave.
Hello?
Did I lag?
Hello, you're back.
I think I lagged.
Cut out. Yeah.
Yes, so Ox Bellows, it is your turn.
Lovely. All right, Ox Bellows, the mountain of a man, is not afraid of exploring the basement.
The basement,
alone,
so. Sure. Here's a basement card.
Thank you. Let's have a look-see, shall we?
The dungeon.
Dungeon. Oh, yeah. Uh-oh. Let's go.
When you enter, make a sanity roll. Ooh.
Oh yeah, I'm not good at those. All right.
There's definitely not a corpse underneath a blanket in the corner.
Yeah,
I'm sure
that's
fine.
That's what's freaking you out.
I believe in you, Ox Bellows. The mental powerhouse that you are.
Two.
Ah.
Is it two or is it three? What does the game say? Two.
Three plus.
The game is saying.
Oh, the game.
One zero.
So it needs to be three plus.
Ouch. Yeah.
So yeah.
So bye-bye. you lose a sanity.
Yeah, it's like is that a body?
Yeah.
Seems fine.
Oh, and an omen. It's omen
time. You gain an omen.
Uh-oh.
So, yeah. Dog.
Ah!
Ox Bellows has a dog. Let's go. It's not a body.
You get your sanity back.
Yay!
Hey! Wow, I'm getting another mite.
Oh, yeah. Ox Bellows feels stronger with a companion at his side.
Here he is. Dog.
Oh, yes.
He walks.
He walks when you move him.
Companion, this mangy dog seems friendly. At least you hope it is. Gain one mite and one sanity now. Lose one might and one sanity if you lose custody of the dog.
Mm-hmm.
Take a small monster token to represent the dog.
We've got
put
a dog.
Put it in your room. Nice.
Oh.
Use a token of a different color from other monsters, if any. Once during your turn, the dog can move to any explored room up to 6 spaces away, using doors and stairs, and then they return. It can pick up, carry, and or drop one item before it returns.
Nice.
The dog isn't slowed by opponents. It can't use one-way passages or rooms that require a roll. It can't carry items that slow movement. This omen can't be dropped, traded, or stolen.
Nice.
Oh.
Make a haunt roll now.
Okay.
Dog is with you in the dungeon.
Yep, and then found a dog. Haunt roll time.
Possibly some
yeah,
ghost.
roll the grey dice.
So how many?
All of them.
All of them.
Oh dear.
And you've got to roll less than a 2.
Oh dear.
Oh,
as in, that's when the haunt starts. So.
Oh, I see.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's grand.
Yeah.
That's great.
Okay.
Yeah. I think this counter is automatically tracking the number of omens we've drawn as well.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Oh, cool.
Unless you've been really quick to press those buttons, it's doing it itself.
Yeah, because I think when you hit the when you hit the start haunt button, it detects the last omen you drew, and automatically sets up for that haunt because it's quite clever.
Oh, nice.
Someone's done
that
some good scripting on this.
Mm. Yeah. Oh my goodness, Ox Bellows is so strong. He's gonna.
Yes.
I'm only 3 might away from my max.
Yes, you are. Your current strength is like probably higher than some people's maximum strength.
Yeah, I'm sitting on 6 so, right now. And I
Zoe, what's your maximum?
Mine. My
7.
Max is 7.
Okay. Great.
I enjoy that Harpress has said, oh, it's Scooby-Doo. Gain one mite and a handful of fleas.
Yeah.
Nice.
Zoe, you're
yes,
up. And you
that's
can,
me.
You can move more now. You're
yeah,
in,
I can
you're in
do
the treehouse.
Maximum 4. I am in the treehouse. Do I have to do a thing to leave the treehouse?
No.
No, I don't. Cool.
You can. There's a door right there, or you can go
yeah.
back upstairs, either via the plant, or if you want to avoid the attic, you can go via the grand staircase.
I might go to the roof landing. I'll go out into the so that
you can't go
what?
To the roof landing currently. You can go to the upper landing. The roof hasn't been revealed yet. Is Discord failing me
Uh-oh.
Again? Discord, hello.
Hello.
Sorry, I don't know what Discord's
hello.
Doing. It's being
no,
weird.
Worries.
So how do I get to the...
You can't get to the roof landing. You can get to the upper landing again.
Okay.
But if you go via the grand staircase rather than the plant, you don't have to roll to get out of the attic.
Okay.
So that would be 1, 2, 3, and then into a room.
Sure. Okay, I will go... 1, 2, 3. Hi, please, game.
Did you just drop?
I lagged
Zoe.
Very far.
Oh,
I no,
see.
I didn't drop her. My movement went off the table.
Sure. There's
yes.
There's your room tile.
Thank you. Flip.
The
servants'
quarters.
I will put it up
okay.
here.
Nice normal room, but you get an omen.
Oh.
Here you go.
The normalest of things.
A girl.
Companion. A girl. Trapped. Alone. You free her. Gain 1 sanity and 1 knowledge now. Lose 1 sanity and 1 knowledge if you lose custody of the girl. This omen cannot be dropped, traded, or stolen. Make a haunt roll now. Do I get a little dog, but it's a girl and it moves?
You do have a girl. I was looking at like different versions of the game, and some of them had a girl token, like a proper girl, but this one doesn't seem to. So I can just give you the little item that says girl. I think it's where will it be? There's a lot of tokens. I have, because I have the actual game of this, it's like there's so many little tokens. I just have them all together in the box and then searching through trying to find them every time. Where would the girl be? Not a monster. Not an item.
Where was the dog?
The dog was just out on the table.
Oh.
He's animated as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's like one of the standard...
is it TTS?
Standard TTS things, yeah. Can't find the girl. Numbered item? No. I'll find you a girl, don't worry. Just carry on.
Okay. I'll hold you to that.
I've got some like NPCs somewhere.
Yeah.
Dun, 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 dun. Humans. I've got 1,169 humans. I'm sure one of them's a girl.
That's a lot of humans.
You have quite a collection of humans, though.
Yeah, when we were playing D&D in TTS, I collected a lot of different...
A lot of humans.
Assets from all over the place.
Like
here
a
you
small
go.
Village.
Here's a girl.
Got a drawer full of girls.
Don't say it like that.
Come, girl.
There you go. That's
friend.
Your girl. It's not animated like Trelawney's dog.
Also, she has no base.
Yes, she's just a girl.
Hello, girl.
Faceless child.
So there you go, you're...
Does she have no face?
She's alright. No, she's got
a
face.
She does have a face. She's fine. She's got a light print on as well. Good choice.
Well, she was in the servant's quarters, so she's like a servant girl. Oh, I'll make it like the same size as you, so you're like...
Okay, fair.
You're like twins running around.
Mm-hmm.
You found a friend.
Sufficiently haunted.
Yeah.
Nice. And then you did not start the haunt with your role. So it's
Jenny. Hang on. When I gain the girl, I get one sanity and one knowledge.
Yes.
Cool.
Make sure you
one
keep
sanity
that.
And one knowledge. Cool. My knowledge has gone up. My sanity has remained the same, but obviously it's gone up.
Jenny, you are in the laundry.
I'm in the laundry. And I don't need to do anything to get out of here. I would like to try and get to the study, but that requires going across the collapsed room.
I mean,
it doesn't
for you, because you've got the blueprint, and you can move to any square with a dumb waiter. You can travel between two rooms that have dumb waiters.
Yeah.
So for one movement, you can jump straight to the study.
Well, then I am gonna do that.
Yeah.
Howdy.
Mm-hmm.
And
open the door.
Why is there a white explorer token on the floor in the study?
Oh, that's to mark that I've taken my mental
thing.
Trait.
Roger,
so you can only get it once per game.
Okay.
Okay, yes, I would like to open this door.
Mm-hmm. There you go. The
kitchen.
So you get an omen. The bloodstone.
That sounds ominous. Smooth and the deep green of a midnight forest. The stone is veined with crimson. Mm-hmm. They say you can't get blood from a stone. They didn't ask this one.
Foreboding.
Once per turn, you may lose one from any trait to add two dice, maximum of eight dice, to your trait roll.
Oh, okay.
Make a haunt roll now.
So it's kind of like damaging yourself to do better at something.
Yeah.
Which could be handy for you once the haunt starts, whether you're good or evil.
Right,
so yeah, then... Are these grey dice? All six of them.
Oops. Nope. All of them?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh. That's five.
That was a...
Oh, that's okay.
Yeah. That's the good thing about TTS is there's no such thing as a cocked dice. It always tells you what it is.
It always knows.
So that was close, but it did not start the horn.
Yeah.
And then you still have movement, so if you wanted, you could move one back to the study, and if you end your turn there, you get another
smarter
mental trait. Yes. So you add one to either your knowledge or your sanity. And I'll put your
token down. I'm going to add a knowledge.
Cool.
You're
now
4-4-4-4.
Yes.
Lovely. Father Reinhardt will move through the kitchen, open another door, look for a ground tile. Here we go. It's the library.
It also matches up. Oh, it's so pleasing.
Yes, so the way things work is you always have to have a free door on every floor, so and you always have to make the doors match. So this is now closed off this loop, and the only way through is to go back to the treehouse.
Oh wow! Okay.
So I go in here. There's an event, and then once per turn, I gain a knowledge. If I end once per game, I can get more knowledge. Great.
Oh, so you can just camp the library if you're...
No, what is once per game, similar to the study.
Oh, okay.
So I'll put a token there again. But first I do the event.
Just live in the library.
An angry being!
Oh no!
It emerges from the slime on the wall next to you. Make a speed roll. Oh, I'm not very fast. My speed is still 3.
Who left all the slime on the wall in the library anyway?
Slimy books. Oh yes! 4. Oh, I still take a die of mental damage. Oh, I needed a 5. Okay.
That's okay, because you can gain if you lose a knowledge, you can gain a knowledge.
True. Well, it's not one mental damage, it's a die of mental damage. So it could be nothing, or it could be one or two. It's nothing! Yay!
Hey!
Yay!
Great.
Good job, dice.
That goes away. And then I will clone this token to say that I've taken the knowledge from the library. Reading is good for you, kids.
Whiskey learning. Yeah. Look, there's like two knowledge, there's a study, there's a library, but to get to them, you have to traverse a collapsed room.
Yeah.
So, like, you can have the knowledge.
You win some, you lose some.
Damn.
Yeah. Well, Ox Bellows, you're in the basement with a dog. What would you like to do?
We're going to proceed
through the dungeon of sanity.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So it's only when I enter this room, so hopefully.
Yes. Let's find a basement tile. There you go.
Nice.
The Mystic Elevator!
Oh nice.
Ooh.
This is the best tile.
Oh, nice. Of course it is. Ox Bellows found it. Once per turn, roll 2 dice and move this room next to any other open door on any floor. And you roll. So any floor, upper floor, ground floor, basement, then take 1 die of physical damage. Oh, as in it crashes.
Yes. Right. So it's not without risk, but it lets you go move around a lot.
Sure.
So you can do that now if you want.
Or
you could use the rest of your movement to go back to the basement landing, ready to open another door if you'd like.
Yeah, I think I might do that. The only thing is, when I enter the dungeon, I'm going to have to.
You would have to make another sanity roll. Yes,
sanity.
You can.
Let's do it.
Okay.
Let's do it. Ox Bellows fears nothing, okay? Not even
you're just leaving the elevator there?
Yes.
Well, no, he's the only one who knows where it is now, so if he's the bad guy, then he can go and collect it for nefarious purposes.
Right, sanity. Sanity check. I have 3 points of sanity currently.
So okay.
You got this.
3-on-3.
I hope so. Go on, Ox Bellows. You can do it.
Oh, that's 3.
Oh, that's 3. Nice. Oh, yes.
He's fine.
Oh, yes. Yeah, he's been through this before, and I've got my trusty companion.
Yeah, the dogs help. Dog helps.
100%.
Puppy.
It definitely looks like a wolf, but
well, yeah, it's probably a wolf. It's a horror dog, so it's just particularly angry and scary looking.
Oh, when I enter the dungeon, do I have to draw another omen?
No, it's only when it's first revealed.
Okay, cool. No worries. All right, yeah, I think that's my turn.
Nice, Zoe. You are upstairs in the servants' quarters with a friend.
She is a girl.
She's, to be honest, she's more normal looking than you.
True.
You're kind of crazed.
I mean,
you've got a trivia murder party doll with you.
Yeah, it's my friend.
That is a cursed looking teddy there. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. How rude! That's my favorite teddy.
Well, do you want to open a door in the servants' quarters?
Yeah, I think we will. Yeah, let's do that.
Here you go. Put it wherever you like.
A solarium. I need to rotato potato it. Mm-hmm. It go here, I think. Oh, no. Please. Plop. Okay. It has a item. Mm-hmm. If you end your turn here, you may discard an item to gain one sanity. Come, child.
Nice. Well, yeah, that's the well, here's an item, and then you can decide if you want to keep it or not.
Sorry, yes. In my mind I heard the implication of, like, you can discard an item card to gain one sanity. Come, child. I shall discard you. Discard the child. Become more sane.
Left by a previous explorer, there seems to be something on the tape. You should totally watch it.
Oh.
When you draw this card, put a number of triangular knowledge token rolls.
Sorry,
a triangular knowledge roll tokens on this card equal to the number of explorers.
Mm-hmm.
An explorer in possession of the camcorder can take a knowledge roll token to gain one knowledge. You may not gain a knowledge roll token if you already have one. When there are no tokens left, discard this card and all those knowledge roll tokens.
Okay.
So it's like pass around the camcorder game.
Yes, although you maybe don't want to do it until we know who's evil.
Who's bad.
And who isn't. Yeah. So.
Because I might be bad.
Here's four tokens, and I think.
Can I take mine now?
You can take yours now.
But.
No, and then if you wanted, because you're in the solarium, you could also take a knowledge token, discard the camcorder, and also take some sanity.
That sounds great.
So you benefit, no one else benefits. Yeah. But you benefit twice.
A camcorder, right? Cool. Sure, let's do that.
Okay, well, I'll take these tokens back.
Okay. So I get one knowledge and one sanity. Woo!
Yeah, and then... This goes. Nice. This goes back.
Oh, what? I never saw a camcorder. No, shh.
Just quickly fast forward through the video and then chuck it out the window.
Just like just get like a little eldritch portal and you just lob it into that and get discarded.
Nice. And then you had to end your turn in order to do that. So it's now Jenny's turn. If you want to open a door, you've got to go to the treehouse.
Or upstairs.
But you can't. Yeah, you can go up or down.
Or through the floor.
Well, you can go down with the dumbwaiter anyway.
To
the basement landing, so you don't have to fall.
Oh yeah, you could just go down the dumbwaiter from the study to the. Oh, to a landing. You don't even have to. Could you not go to the?
Not the roof landing. You can only go up or down one. Okay. Or if you wanted to gain an extra knowledge, you could just go to the library.
Ooh, that's true. Yeah, I think I will do that while I'm here close by.
That's a good plan.
Nice.
Put the token there. Great. Add a knowledge. And then it's Father Reinhardt's turn. My speed is still 3. I'm scared of the collapsed room. So
yes.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go 1, 2, get in the dumbwaiter.
Okay.
Up or down? Up or down? Who do I trust more? Let's go down.
Come to the attic. It's lovely.
He's got a haunted down. Victorian girl with her.
Yes. Yeah.
Greetings, father. I found a dog.
Bless you, my child. Bless your dog. I'm going in the storm cellar.
Oh.
Ooh.
Okay. I get another item, which I could maybe...
Oh, there's no waiter.
Yes. I could maybe put it in a box if I need. Oh, hello. Gain a might, speed, a knowledge, and a sanity. If I lose the amulet, I lose 3 of all of those.
Oh, jeez.
Ouch.
I'm definitely putting this in the box.
Yeah, that goes in the box.
100%.
What do I need to put it in the box? On your turn, you may remove the item from the box and put a different box. There we go. Amulet in the box.
Yeah.
Yay.
There we go.
Well, we definitely don't want you to be the baddie, because you've got some funky stuff now.
Well, I mean, I've got good knowledge, good sanity. My might and speed
still aren't
great. But my might jumped from 2 to 4, so...
Yeah.
That's useful.
Right. Interesting.
I'm going to stay in the storm cellar, so that's the end of my turn. Nice. Zoe and friend. You have to go back to the servants' quarters.
Hello? How's it going?
Because it's... Trelawney. Oh, no, Trelawney. Sorry, Oxbellows.
Yeah, no,
I missed you. That's my bad.
It's okay. Oxbella's knowledge is not great either. He wouldn't have remembered.
He doesn't know which way is clockwise and which way is anti-clockwise.
Just playing with a dog.
Yeah.
Right. I think Oxbella's is going to go to the storm cellar with his dog.
Okay. Hello.
Get in the dumbwaiter. Hello. And go to the study.
So you can only use the dumbwaiter to go to landings.
Oh, I see.
It's the blueprint that lets Jenny... In that case, dumbwaiters.
We shall go to the stick.
Sure.
And
so that's
do I have movement left?
That's 2 movement.
Okay. Then I am tempted to risk the staircase. No, to risk the collapsed room rather.
You want more knowledge?
I do. I want to remember my birthday.
Fair.
So, let's have a look. If you end your turn here, you may discard an item. No, I won't go there. Right, I'll go back to the entrance then, I guess. Is that my movement?
If your movement was 4, then yeah.
The other possibility would be to go treehouse and then open a door with no movement left, but...
Oh, true.
Yeah, you could have gone upstairs if you wanted.
Maybe I'll go to the tree. Oh, actually, no, I've moved myself here now.
You could have got there... You could have got there sooner if you don't mind risking the graveyard, because you could have gone secret stairs to the graveyard.
Oh, yeah.
But then you'd need a sanity roll of 4+.
Oh, you know what? If I'm allowed, yeah. I think I'll do that. I'll gamble in the graveyard.
Sure. So that's one movement.
Yeah.
Make a sanity roll.
Go on. I will.
Here we go.
Okay. Right.
This is risky.
Oxbello is he's now fully accustomed to gambling with his sanity. So, let's go.
Ooh.
That was a good lob.
Hey, 4, you're okay.
Hey, nice.
Hey.
Oxbello's sheer self-confidence, whether it's warranted or not, allows him to pass through. Nice. Now, to gamble again, is it?
Yeah.
Speed roll of 5+ to avoid falling. Otherwise, I'm going to be seeing you again, father.
That would be great if you run up the stairs rather than just fall straight back down.
Right, so I use 4 dice because my speed is 4.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah. Okay.
That's not good.
Oh, no. No, that's not.
No.
Okay. So, you fall into a new basement tile.
Oh.
Which, do you want to put it on the landing or on the cellar?
Let's put it on the land.
Two items? What?
Yes, this is the vault.
And an event?
Oh.
Holy wows.
Bonk.
So yeah, you need a knowledge roll of 6+. And then you get two items.
Oh dear.
Does the event happen first?
Yes, the event.
Okay.
The event. Let's put it over here. By.
Is it even possible?
First you take a die of physical damage.
No.
Physical damage?
So roll one of your die.
Oh, okay. Right. Here we go. Oxbellows doesn't believe in damage.
Two.
Oh, it's two.
So. You can do that one speed, one might, or two might, whatever you want.
Oh, you know what? I'm gonna go, what? What if I went two speed?
You can be slow and strong if you want to be.
No, I'll go one might, one speed. Okay. That's the most sensible option, because my might number doesn't change, and my speed only changes by one, so that's
okay.
Fine.
Now you do the event.
Nice. Mutant house pet. Oh no! What, I'm acquiring a menagerie.
Amazing.
Not quite. I have read on.
A muling. A muling from inside the wall. Is it a cat? A second yowl erupts from the same spot in the wall.
Yeah.
A different feline voice. Two cats. You hear only one scratching to get out. Two heads. You claw at the plaster to find out. You must attempt a speed roll of 4+. Oh no! Oh. If you fail, take 1 point of physical damage from the pet's attack. If you succeed, gain 1 sanity point and 1 speed.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'd read ahead and you were like, oh, it's fine, I'll just be slow. And I'm like,
yeah.
Okay.
So, what's the speed roll? So that's
three now, yeah.
So, right. You can do it, Oxbellows. I believe in you, and you should believe in yourself. Oh,
three.
Is that okay? Yes, that's what I need.
No, you need
no,
four.
No, it's not. Oh no! Oxbellows, you didn't believe hard enough.
So yeah, 1 point of physical.
1 point of physical damage. Oh Jesus!
You want to be slow, or go back to your starting strength?
Slow. Oxbellows is slow. My movement is down to 2.
Okay.
Oxbellows, you'll be slow. You will not sacrifice your strength, Oxbellows. Right, nice. Okay, I think that's...
Do you want to try a knowledge roll to empty the vault?
Yeah, go on. I don't think it's possible. Because my knowledge...
It's two. No, your maximum is 4. You need a 6.
Yeah.
So... Nope. You just bash your head against the vault door and nothing
happens.
Yeah, go on.
How well do I bash my head against the vault door?
Canonically, you're trying anyway. Amazing.
Not very well.
No, not very well. Nice.
I'll space out for a little bit. Alright, nice. That is the end of Mox Bella's turn.
Zoe.
Hello.
Plus one.
I am 8. I have a friend. And another friend. My teddy is my friend too.
Sure.
I am going to go out of the solarium.
Mm-hmm.
Come, child. Oh, she fell over.
Yeah. That's what comes
she
from
wants
having
to stand
no base.
On my thingy for some reason.
I could lock her to you if you want. You'd be,
that's all right. Your she's friend. Fun. The drawing room.
Ooh.
When discovered, draw one card of any type. Ooh.
Nice.
So, I could draw an omen.
You could.
Your box is an omen, isn't it? I think item is probably best, right?
I mean, items. Items that I think are generally always like either good or useful in some way, some more than others. Omens are generally good. Sometimes they're less good. Sometimes they're like really good. And then, yeah. It's like most, I think more often than not, the person who starts the haunt with the omen is like the bad person. But okay. Not always, so you never know.
I'll take an item. Okay. I've taken the whole stack. I've got one. Flippy flip. Chalk. I'm definitely the not creepiest child. a simple drawing stick made out of ground, bone, and wax. you may roll knowledge instead of might on defense rolls.
Ah, so when someone attacks you, you can outthink them instead of outfight them with chalk for some reason.
I'm struggling to straighten my... Oh, there we go.
Nice.
Chalk, what is my knowledge and might?
I
am knowledgerer than I am might.
True, yes. And you can take it up to 5 sometime soon.
Yes.
And there are two places where you could increase your knowledge on the board if you want to go down there.
Yes. I should be in the drawing room.
Yes,
though, right?
You're in the drawing room.
Okay. Child? No. Child.
But you still have 2 movement if you want to go somewhere else.
She insists on standing in the center of the room.
Oh yeah, she's snapping. I can turn her grid.
Grid snapping off. Yes, if you could ungrid her. Thank you. That's much better. Thank you.
So do you want to move back into a different room?
Am I allowed to make another room, or am I?
No, you can only open one door, okay. But you can use your movement to.
Ooh, could I dumbwaiter somewhere?
Yeah, you can go. You can go up to the roof landing, or you can go down to the grand staircase.
Ooh, given that no one's gone up there and no one wants to be my friend anyway, let's me and my child go upstairs.
Sure.
Come, spooky child.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. My wasading is. I think the further distance I go, if I'm zoomed in, it's more likely to go terribly wrong.
Nice. Well, you are up there. Jenny, you're so knowledgeable.
I am piss smart. I would like to.
You can attempt to cross the collapsed room, or you can spend an extra movement to go to the study and travel from there.
I think I would like to explore the basement.
Okay.
So...
You want to fall through the collapsed room?
No, I would rather not fall if I can avoid it.
Yes.
Yeah, so,
I will go through the study and take the dumbwaiter.
Wizard Zed! Thanks for the sun. So yeah, you can go to the basement landing or the storm cellar.
And is that 3? So I got 1 more?
Yes.
Or you go in vault hunting.
Yeah, I think I'll go to the vault.
Ooh.
I hear dog noises. I want to see the dog.
You pet the dog.
and hi, puppy.
You can attempt a knowledge roll. Try and get 6.
Have...
6 on 4 dice. Not impossible.
I have 4.
Mm-hmm. You could use your bloodstone if you wanted. But it would hurt you.
No, I'll pass.
3. You do not open the vault.
Oops, I'm back. And I guess, does anything else happen? Am I just here?
No, if that's all your movement, then that's that.
Yep.
Okay, Father Reinhardt continues through the storm cellar. Unless I want to go to the vault.
That is a mighty large stack of towels. Like, the scaling of those folded towels is enormous.
Well, it's the storm cellar, so I guess it's like blankets for...
Yeah.
Storm cellar, you'd have like food supplies, water, blankets.
Yeah, I guess.
Yeah, it looks like a tarp.
But they're still, compared to like, there's a chest over there, and they're still enormous.
Yeah, well, I guess it's probably got to function as bedding as well.
Yeah.
You don't know how long you're going to be in the storm cellar.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Basement tile. The gymnasium.
Oh, this is where Oxbellows belongs.
once per game, if you end your turn here, gain a speed. Nice.
Hey.
I'll take Oxbellows needs to return.
And an omen. What have we got? A letter. Scrawled in ink, or whatever. You may hand one of your explorer tokens to another explorer, On your turn, you may move to that explorer's room, then discard this omen, and the explorer discards your explorer token.
Oh.
So I can use this to teleport to someone.
Someone?
At some point, but you have they have to have your explorer token first, no?
I don't know. It doesn't say I have to do that now. No. It says I may hand.
Yeah.
Sure.
I think
presumably, do you have to be near the other person to hand it to them, or is it you as the player?
I don't know. I think this is as the player, because the letter is like a magical letter that I received from someone. So, sure. Let's say I've got a letter from Jenny.
Yay.
She sent me a letter to come to the haunted house, and that's why I'm here.
So yeah, just in case the date went badly.
Yeah.
Oh, father! What are you doing here?
So in the future, I can teleport to you, which might be useful. If one of us is evil, then that could be very useful. Or unuseful. I've rolled...
Oh, that was a good roll.
A lot. Seven.
Many rolls.
Oh, wow, there's more over there. Oh, jeez.
So the haunt does still not start.
Right.
Yay.
And then I'm going to end my turn and gain a speed. So I'm up to five. Ox bellows.
Do you need to put your face in there?
Oh yeah, I'll do that.
Ox bellows hears the call of Broden.
Yeah.
And he lumbers in the general direction. He is ready.
You could only move two, though.
Of the place.
He can't reach.
Father! Father, I beg of you. Yeah. Witness my penance of the plate.
Nice.
I will earn Broden's favor once again.
Yeah. Well, that's it. Ox just slowly stumbles.
Yeah. Lumbering forward,
With a dog looking at you like, I can go faster than you.
Yeah. The dog's running forwards and then running back and looking at you and then running forwards again.
Yeah, the dog can move six.
Yep, the dog is very, very fast.
I guess there's like, the dog doesn't have its own like knowledge, so you can't send it to the vault for you.
No,
true.
It could only pick up items.
Dog knowledge.
Yeah. What?
Zoe.
What causes an item to be dropped? Only death.
You can attack someone to steal an item.
Okay.
Basically, when you attack someone, it's like a contested roll. And then you can either do damage or steal an item.
Okay. Well, I guess I'm going to take an upmost
open
house.
A roof. Sure. Please, here's an upper one.
There's a roof. I will flip.
The chapel.
The chapel! Oh, maybe now the father will want to be my friend.
So, there's an event and you can gain a sanity after the end
last
of your turn.
Please. Okay.
Here is an event.
Here you go. Come, child.
A ghost in the machine.
Oh. The crackling of static startles you as a small television sparks to life.
In the chapel.
Through the snowy image, you make out the shape of a child!
It's you or your friend.
You make out the shape of a child playing somewhere in the house. She stops her game, turns towards you, and beckons you to join her. The television goes black once again.
There's three of them now.
Children unite! You must attempt the sanity roll. 0-2, lose a might. Oh! And all explorers can only move one space until my next turn. Hmm. 3+, draw a roof tile and put it in the house. How many sanities? I don't think I've done a sanity roll yet, have I?
Six. Wow, I'm pretty sure you're fine.
That's six die, right?
Yeah. See how many zeros you roll.
That's four. I need more. Why? Game. Oh, okay.
No, you're fine.
That's six.
So you get a roof tile and you teleport to it.
Ooh.
So you don't end your turn in the chapel.
Ow.
Ooh,
panic room.
Nice. You get another event.
Yeah. When you exit, you may attempt a speed roll. If successful, move to any room with a dumb waiter. Exciting.
Nice. Yeah. So you get another event, and then
you
still have speed, so you can keep moving.
Go back
so
to the chapel.
Maybe you could get back to the chapel.
Oh, not quite though, because it's one. No, it was
you did
one to open the door.
This doesn't count as anything. So
magic.
Two, three
so
gets
go
you back.
Back. Yeah.
Well, we'll see what this.
What the. As you look back the way you came, you see nothing. Well, that's right, because I didn't.
You teleported, yeah.
Just empty fog and mist, where a room used to be. Yeah. You pick up the tile for the room you are in, after setting everything on it aside.
It's...
put it somewhere else on the same floor
of
the house. So it's still
it literally just it teleports to the other side of the landing.
And put back anything you set aside.
Almost nothing happens.
Door, yeah.
Amazing.
That was a useless event.
I'm going to be really contrary and just put it there instead.
Sure.
What?
It snaps to just
is
near
it.
That's
okay.
Fine.
But the gap is larger or higher. Well, it looks like it. Anyway. Oh, the child fell over. Child.
Oh no, save the child.
Right. So that was my second movement.
So you still only used one of your actual movements. So
two, three.
You can go back to the chapel, sure.
Amazing.
The child wants to find the telly again and is going to press their hands against the screen like there was a child in here. That's you. That's an old man.
I can change it. There we go.
Okay. What is that button again?
So I gain just running around on the roofs.
Yeah, I gain less sanity.
Yeah,
it's
pretty high. Jenny,
me. Where am I?
You can attempt to open the vault again. Discord.
Oh, you cut out.
Hi, sorry.
Dave? Hello.
Hi.
Yes, you can attempt to open the vault before you leave if you'd like.
Alright, let's give this one more try. Got four. Nice.
Not quite.
That's,
what did I need?
Six.
Nope. Two blankies, two twos.
Nope. Oops, your turn. Your turn.
Okay. Nice. Here we go. You can open a door on the basement landing or go all the way through to the gymnasium if you want. Or to the mystic elevator.
I will come back here and open this door.
Sure. Here you go. The crypt. Ooh.
Oh no.
If you end your turn, take a point of mental damage. Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Okay.
So you get an event.
That's how you get the mental damage. You drop the crypt on your head.
Yes. The beckoning.
Ooh. Outside. You must get outside. Fly to freedom. Each explorer in the gardens, graveyard, tower, on the balcony, or in a room with an outside-facing window must attempt a sanity roll.
Okay.
I have stained glass windows, but not a window.
I mean, I think that counts.
Probably. It's probably an outside-facing window.
Yeah.
It's okay, I'm quite sanitary.
There's no windows in the basement, so it doesn't apply to the rest of us.
I'm good. 3+, you back away from the ledge. 0-2, you jump to the patio.
I don't know what the dice is. Oh,
that's
5.
Fine. Yes.
No, you're good.
Oh, cool.
You do not jump out of the stained glass window.
Nice.
I'm glad.
Would have been epic
pretty,
if
you
did.
So that was what? Two movement.
That was two. I would like to not end my turn in this room.
Good plan.
So I will go back here. And then I've got one more, right? Am I four? Yeah.
Yeah.
Do I want to go somewhere else?
Upstairs, you can go to the gym to get a speed. You can go right around in the Mystic Elevator.
Where do the secret stairs go?
To the graveyard.
Graveyard.
And then you have to make a sanity roll to get out of the graveyard. So they're a little dangerous.
I think I will just go up the normal stairs.
Yep.
Back to here?
No. I always forget no, where the... Yeah, I think it's the staircase.
I think so. That would make sense. Okay. I'll be there. I'm good.
Nice.
Thanks.
So it's now Father Reinhardt's turn. I will continue through the gymnasium as this is the only free door now in the basement. Here we go. Because this is only one door, I have to discard it and draw another one.
Can we read it though to see what we missed out on?
We missed out on knowledge roll. You lose a sanity.
Oh, pentagram chamber. Okay, so not too much of a loss then.
Nope. Another basement. Does it have another door? It does. There we go.
Ooh, another muerte.
The menagerie.
You're going to be so movement-y. I hope you're not evil.
Once per game, when you end your turn here, get a physical trait. Nice. But first I do an event. The fly trap. An enormous exotic plant stands beneath an elaborate rig of lights and plumbing. Its leaves are brown and withered. Its giant flower pod stands partially open, waiting for sustenance. It needs water. It needs to be fed. Your blood. Take one die of physical damage and put the plant token in the room. Take this card. When the haunt is revealed, when any hero, traitor, or monster enters this room, you may attempt a Might 7 attack against them. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
So, first I take a die of physical... Yes! Zero.
Nice.
And then I make another plant. Where was the plant?
Oh, we can't climb this one.
There's too many things. Plant number three. There we go.
Oh, we have different... Oh, okay.
Nice.
Great. So if anyone else comes through here, I can attack them.
So it's now your plant. You have a blood bond.
Yes. And then I'm going to end my turn and gain a physical trait. I'm going to take another speed, so I go up to 6.
Oh, it just changed the bottom of it.
Speedy priest.
Nice. Yeah. Great.
Speedy priest.
Ox bellows.
Nice. Oh, finally. I'm home. Right, I would like to utter a prayer to our father. Quad Father, who art in the Iron Temple, swole be thy frame, thy kingdom come, thy lifts be done, with the deadlift as well as the squat rack. Give us this day our daily shake, and forgive us our cheat days, as we forgive those who skip leg day. Lead us not into cardio, but deliver us from the elliptical, for thine is the glory, the power clean, and the glute ham raise. Forever and ever. Boy, men.
Wow.
I feel invigorated. Beautiful. I end my turn and feel invigorated and gain a speed.
Nice.
The quad father heard my pleas and was merciful.
Okay.
Now, this may be really magic, inspiring. Did that come off the top of your head? Or is
it
that...
did. Yeah, that was entirely off the cuff.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, you have a magical brain.
Yeah.
I'm adding my plant.
Oh, amazing. Are you doing a bit of gardening, are we, Father?
This is my plant friend.
Oh, hello!
Bit smaller. Here we go.
Oh my goodness.
Turn off the snap.
He's a bit big still.
Well, he's strong. He can attack anyone. He takes up most of the room.
You need to name him.
Jeff.
Of course.
He can attack.
Oh, yes, he can. Oh, wow.
This, yeah, the standard TTS models. This is what they do.
Oh no, you can die him.
Yeah.
No, he's not dead.
No,
he's alive.
I don't know how to make it stop.
Mode. There we go.
Okay, he finished.
Zoe, what are you up to in the roof? Discord, why you do this to me?
What? I...
Hello?
Sorry, I was naming the tree Jeff. He's called Jeff now. When you mouse over, it's Jeff.
Nice, good. Whenever anyone's not talking now, I don't know if it's Discord dying on me or not.
Oh, sorry, I was concentrating on naming the plant.
Important work, sure, yeah. I understand.
Yeah.
I think...
Back to the
I
roof.
Might go in a panic room in order to try and leave the panic room by dumbwaiter.
Okay.
Because then I can come to the library and try and be more clever or something, maybe.
Sure. So that would take
three... But I'd have to do a roll, right?
Yeah, so it would be...
I'd have to go one, two...
And then your third is trying to leave, but you might end up anywhere.
I presume if I... Yeah, if I fail, I will just walk out into the room and then I can open a door.
Yeah.
Cool. So speed roll must be +3 if I want a dumbwaiter.
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
You're sorry, my 4. You should be... Got a good chance.
Here's hoping.
Nice.
Yeah! Cool. So I will go to the study, I think.
The study? Sure.
Blonk. Child. Accompany me. There you
go. We go. And then turn it to...
Orange. Yeah. So I gain one mental trait.
Yes. One so sanity or knowledge.
Knowledge? Yeah.
Knowledge.
Cool. Knowledge. And that ended my turn, power. I think.
Jenny.
The knowledge is power.
Oh, this is so true. They say.
Mm-hmm. You are on the grand staircase.
There's a square shadow on the table near my end, and it's bothering me. Is that the skybox that rains? Where my hand is, there's like a little cube shadow.
Oh, that's your hand, so you can put... You can put cards into your hand so that other people can't
see them. Oh, why is it there?
Where? Oh, you mean the one up in the sky? Yeah, that's the rain.
Is that what's causing that shadow? Yes, it is!
Yeah, like, you zoom way out, yeah.
Okay. Thank you. You've removed the shadow of pest rain. Because I couldn't see it when I zoomed out, but I guess I wasn't looking for a white cube. Cool. Thank you. That was bugging me considerably.
Jenny.
I am on the grand staircase. Mm-hmm. I would like to go up the stairs.
Mm-hmm.
So that's one.
Yep.
And then...
Yeah, you can go to the roof.
Oh.
Roof.
Then I'm going to open another door on the door. The side.
This one. The game room. Yay, gamers.
All right.
Oh, it has a window.
It does.
And a bearskin rug.
Yes.
Yes.
The games we have are chess and poker, I guess. I don't know if there's any board games in this.
Looks like Texas Hold'em.
Yeah. There might be board games on this shelf, but maybe these are D&D reference books.
Mm.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, definitely.
You could play was it Hoopla with the antlers? Ring toss?
Sure, that's the game that they have in mind, I'm sure.
Let's go!
Silence.
Uh-oh. Underground, everything goes silent.
Oh,
even
no.
The sound of breathing is gone. Uh-oh. Each explorer in the basement must attempt a sanity roll.
Poor
on a 4+, you wait calmly for your hearing to return. One to three, you scream a silent scream and take one die of mental damage. Ooh. Zero, you freak out, take two dice of mental damage.
Okay, my sanity is 7, so I'm feeling good.
Oh, jeez.
I'm fine.
Oh, no, I've got 3 sanity.
Poor Ox Bellows.
Ox Bellows, Broden, guide me, watch over me.
Oh no.
Could have been worse.
It's better than none.
One die of mental damage.
So it could still be nothing.
It could be none.
I'm gonna say,
Broden, please, why hath thou forsaken me?
Hey!
Yay! Nice.
Cool.
Amazing. I'll take that.
I was wondering if you could return someone else's dice, and I found the
answer. You can. Just a button.
Nice. Ooh, that was good.
So, do you want to stay in the game room, Jenny?
Let's see. That was 3. I'll go back up to the landing here.
Sure.
Oh yeah, I need my explorer token to mark that I've.
Oh yes.
Oh yeah, yes. Done your reps.
Done some. Yeah, exactly. completed my set.
Mm-hmm. You know? Change it to red.
Nice.
I will continue on and open another door. I might eventually go back to the vault because I'm smart. The statuary corridor.
Oh.
It has an event.
And not much else.
Smoke. Smoke billows around you. You cough, wiping away tears. Put the smoke token in this room. The smoke blocks lines of sight from adjacent rooms. An explorer rolls 2 fewer dice on all trait rolls.
While in that one room, though.
Sure, as long as we don't need to use the corridor for anything.
Which, if you're naughty, someone would be like, oh, I cannot see the giant flytrap tree man.
Yeah, line of sight, I think, only matters if you've got, like, a ranged weapon.
Okay.
You get, like, a gun item that can fire through multiple rooms.
Damn.
Okay, my speed is 6, so that's 1. We're going to go back. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then I'm going to attempt to open the vault with my 6 knowledge.
Dave is way OP already. He has so much.
How did you become so fast, Father?
I mean, it has gone up 3. I'm not sure how. I think it was the amulet. 6.
Oh.
There we go.
I only saw the 3 blank ones, and then I was like, oh, you haven't made it.
I get 2 dice. More items. I don't think I'm going to put any in the box. The amulet's too risky. I've got a healing salve. Oh. I can apply it to myself or another explorer in the same room. You can take your physical stats back to the regular value. And a bottle. Once during your turn after the haunt, roll 3 dice. And then you either get good or bad things.
Yep. 0 being very bad.
Yes. So I guess we'll just hang on to those and then maybe I'll use them later.
0 would kill me.
Is smoke discarded now?
Sorry, what?
Is smoke discarded or is that?
No, I'll leave it there so that if anyone is in the room with the smoke, we remember what it does. Fair. But that's the end of my turn. Ox Bellows.
Nice. I think I am going to go 1, 2, open the door.
Sure.
And bring my dog with me.
Here's your basement tile. The catacombs.
You need a name for your dog.
Oh, yeah, true.
Oh, yeah. I think I'll call him Dox Dellows.
Uh-huh.
Great. Uh-huh.
Excellent.
I'm going to attempt to move the ground floor because it's getting close to everything else.
You can attempt a sanity roll of 6+ to cross. If you fail, you stop moving.
There we go.
So I need to make a sanity roll if I want to move through this room, and it needs to be 6 or higher.
Yes.
Is that it?
I think you get lost in, like, the maze of the catacombs if you...
Oh, wow, okay. So, can I...
It's fine, it's fine.
Have one movement. Do I still have...
Okay.
No, sorry. This is my...
it's on the line, so I'm like...
No, this is where I have to end my turn. Okay, cool. Yep, I'll end my turn here.
You can make your sanity roll now if you want. Oh, it's also
I have
an.
To? Is it?
You don't have maybe. To. It's also an omen, omen space.
Mm. Oh, why okay, is it catacombs sure. Asterisk?
Yeah.
It's. I don't remember. It's probably a reason, but nothing we need to worry about.
Yeah.
Here's
sure.
Here's
yeah.
Your omen.
What
the medallion?
Omen.
Oh, that was a blast from the past.
Mm.
Jeez.
You're immune to certain things.
With the pentagram. Yeah, you are immune to the effects of the pentagram
what?
Chamber, crypt, and graveyard. Make a haunt roll now.
Oh. Nice. Well, pentagram chamber got bucketed in the bin.
Yes.
We do have a graveyard.
The crypt is a dead end, but sometimes it comes up in the haunt. You have to go and do things.
Okay.
In those particular places.
So I need
places.
To roll
or
all
six.
Of them, don't I?
Yeah. If you roll yeah. 6 or more, the haunt starts.
Oh dear.
Oh gosh.
Oh, 6 or less,
five.
Sorry.
5.
So, yes, the haunt starts.
Okay.
So, uh-oh. It was the medallion revealed in the catacombs. So if I press this button, it should detect that.
Oh, Archeloni is the traitor!
Yes, medallion, ooh. And then uh-oh. Catacombs.
Where it well.
The medallion did something to me. Just enter the catacombs, pick up a strange object in the catacombs. Why would you do that? I don't know.
So
Valor's sulfate to do so.
This is haunt number 49. So, oh yeah, if you now see Trelawney, there's a red box over the
oh, yeah.
The things
over here. Yeah.
Oh.
So there's now one that you can only see in, and one that we can only see in. And
oh,
it has it's turned the page to the right one. So don't read it out loud, but
got it.
Read through
sure.
This
could,
thing.
Could we mute Trelawney in Discord so he can't hear us and we can talk about it on stream and then he can like do his studies in darkness and then we can
true,
like,
yes. I'm just gonna kick you from the call for a minute, Trelawney.
No, wait, I can deafen. No.
Oh, I don't know if I trust you. I could server deafen you.
Yeah.
I've server deafened and mute. Great. You wear it well. You can hear one of your friends running through the house, laughing and sobbing at the same time. Just as you're starting to run towards your friend, you feel a powerful wind tear through your very soul, casting it out of your body. You can still see the walls of the house around you, but they're fuzzy and indistinct. A silvery cord now stretches out of you, leading back to your unconscious body.
What?
All you want is to crawl back inside your own flesh, but how? Okay. Tip over your explorer's figure. We're all unconscious.
Oh. What about my friend?
I think they're just waiting by your body.
Cool. Sounds good. I went downstairs, didn't I?
So we get you get a blue monster token. Has it done any of this, or do we need to? I think we still need to do.
I've put myself on my head because I don't know how to knock myself over.
Okay.
And how do I tip over?
You can press F and then you flip.
Right. I'll read through all of this.
Oh, there we go.
How did you do that?
I pressed F.
Oh.
I'll read through all of this and then I'll sort out tokens and things. So we get, we become our souls. Set aside a number of triangular knowledge tokens equal to the number of players.
If you lift yourself up,
equal number of
it, like,
sanity tokens. If there's no current way to move between the basement and the rest of the house, no, that's fine. What we know about Trelawney, he's working with a powerful astral spirit. It can possess an unconscious body. Now, if it can possess an unconscious body, it will be immortal. We win when we destroy the spirit. Once it has been destroyed, you return to your physical body. We can attack the spirit with knowledge or sanity. Each time a hero's attack succeeds, put a knowledge roll or sanity roll.
That was accident.
A token on the hero's character card. When we've collected a number of tokens equal to the number of players, he's destroyed. Okay. We are a disembodied soul. We have retained all of our traits. We can move through walls as if they were connecting doorways, but not through floors and ceilings. You can move up and down the coal chute, collapse room, and gallery. Not affected by any room text that mentions physical.
Hey.
You can use your items, but you can't trade them.
Okay.
You can pick up or acquire. You cannot pick up or acquire new items in any way. If your soul is destroyed, your items are destroyed as well. You can't explore new rooms. Whenever you attack or defend, you use knowledge or sanity.
Okay, so this physical means nothing.
This is actually, I think, good for us and bad for Oxbellows, because he's all about the physical.
Yeah.
And I'm particularly good with knowledge and sanity. So.
Mine aren't terrible, actually. So
this might be a short fight. Anything that would inflict physical damage to your soul inflicts mental damage.
Oh.
You can't use the skull or any weapon card. Special rules. If you attack the astral spirit and lose, you don't take any damage. If you defeat the traitor with a mental attack, he's stunned but doesn't take damage.
Right.
The traitor can attack your unconscious body, inflicting 2 dice of mental damage.
Ah.
And you can't defend.
Mm.
Okay, so...
It says if you win, rolls. Your companion. What's our companion?
So yeah, the if you win bit is you read when you've won. Or Trelawney has a thing to read when.
Right. So it says we set aside a number of triangular knowledge or tokens.
I've got those.
He needs? Because he asked for them as well.
Yeah, I think these are like what we put on his on his player card. Symbolize how well it's going. So we'll just put them there, and then we need tokens to represent ourselves. I wonder if I might just try something. If I clone myself,
he's gonna try something.
Oh, okay. No, so we need a number of triangular knowledge roll tokens equal to players
that's
an equal number of sanity roll.
Can I do this? No, that I was trying to make myself
then he
like
needs an additional
invisible.
Sanity. Okay.
No, I can't. Okay, so let's just get.
You have your big batchy plant as well.
Yeah.
Or if you're also unconscious.
No, I think the plant is fine. I think Oxbellows has a physical form which could be attacked by that. But the astral spirit will be only attacked by us and our mental attacks. Okay, where's my monster tokens? Square tokens. Obstacles. Not banshee.
Yeah, so I think he needs triangly tokens as well as us, doesn't he? Because we need to collect ours in order to win, so he probably also needs to collect them to win on his side, maybe?
Well, I'll tell you what, we can use these, like, these ones. Like, these little...
Ooh! Little not-meeples.
Yes.
Cluedo tokens.
Yeah, these are our souls. Here we go.
Cool.
Zoe, you are... Here you go.
Thanks.
Nice. So, what we need to do is. I assume Trelawney has put. Oh, yeah, look, he's put this purple monster token. That is the astral spirit.
Okay.
We have to float around and attack it.
Get it.
We don't have to collect anything, we just have to attack, right? Yeah, we just have to destroy it with mental attacks. Because if we attack and lose, we don't take damage, but... Yeah, they can find us and attack for us. Cool. I've got this healing salve. that only heals physical, so that is useless.
Yeah, but it might be useful if there's something that says you can use a knight to block an attack or something, maybe. I don't know if that exists.
There's rooms where I can, like, discard an item to get another discarded item, but...
Yeah, wasn't upstairs?
Yeah, I think...
Oh, yeah.
The candle,
right, my
it makes...
away.
That's for an event card.
Yeah,
I don't need
the
that.
Solarium.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can discard an item card to gain
I'm not sure
sanity.
That's worth it. Yeah. Let's... So... The bottle could be very good, or it could be bad. Losing 2 knowledge and 2 sanity would be bad, but gaining knowledge and sanity would be useful. Okay, right. I'll let Trelawney back in. Oxbellows, are you there? You might have still deafened himself. Da, 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 da. Da,
yeah, he's still... Come back!
See? Yeah, I'm just gonna...
Hello?
Go. Nice. Good.
Yep, all good. I understand.
Fabulous.
I'm glad someone does.
Yep.
You're running around laughing and crying at the same time. What's wrong with you, Oxbellows?
Nothing.
It's fine.
So,
do we need these knowledge tokens that have been spoken about? Have we got?
Yeah,
a
we've.
Of those?
I've put knowledge and sanity tokens out.
Okay,
and we're ready.
Yeah.
So, cool. Once the haunt starts, it moves to the player on the left of the traitor. So, Zoe, you're up first.
Oh. Okay. So, I guess I don't know what's happening yet, do I? I'm like, ah.
Well, you somehow know that there's an evil thing you need to go and deal with.
Yeah, but I can go through the floor, right?
You can.
It said clapstrom, so I'm gonna go
the floor.
One, and then where do I come out?
In fact, you don't even need to use the collapsed room, because the collapsed room goes to the basement landing. But the dumb waiter also goes to the basement landing.
Oh,
so you can use one less speed and get to the basement landing.
Spirits can still use dumb waiters.
Yeah, it's just like a tunnel that we float through.
Tunnel floating.
Yes.
Cool. Can I still go in the vault?
I mean,
surely in theory I can just spookily go in.
Yeah, but I've already taken all of the items from it.
It says,
"Oh, boo."
Yeah, and we can't gain any more items. It says,
"Oh, no. Right enough." It did say that. Okay. So I did one, and now what? I'm gonna go 2, 3, 4, and be friends with this tree man.
Sure, he is friendly to you. He likes spirits.
Yeah.
Oh,
hi, Jeff.
Jenny, it is your turn.
Whee! Alright.
Oh, it says in the menagerie you can gain a physical trait, but you can't because you're a ghost. So, that doesn't count.
Alright, I'm on the landing, so I would like to float back down one...
So, yeah, from the roof landing, it's 1, 2, 3 to the basement.
Yes.
Yeah, it can just float down the middle of the stairs. Woo!
And I can go one more, so I will go here.
Sure.
Oh, hang on, though. Could you not have...
Or you could... Oh, you've got your blueprint still. You can still use it.
Yes.
So
yeah, hold on. Where's
you could go one to the upper landing, 2, 3 to the drawing room, and then 4 to the menagerie.
Yeah.
Yay, guest friends.
Yay, free friends.
I will lament to you that I'm sad my Victorian child is not sure what's happening.
My speed is 6, so I'm going to go 1, 2 into the dungeon, and then float through the wall just because I can. 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, there's a naughty monster here. I'm gonna attack it.
Oh, no.
Attack the spirit using... No. I can use knowledge or sanity. So I use sanity because that's 7.
Cough.
Holy cow.
So, I assume you're defending for the spirit, Ox Bellows.
Mm-hmm.
And attacking.
Not only are Dave's stats insane, his picture looks like the sexy Squidward meme, and I can't get past this.
Little bit. Smaller chin. yeah, so I attack with my 7 knowledge. Seven sanity.
Okay, do I have to contest?
Yes, so attacks.
Can I defend with my physical body, or does it have to be with the astral spirit?
I'm just checking.
If you're attacking the astral spirit, I guess it's a contested roll with the astral spirit.
Yes. Does it say what its stats are?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Cool.
When effect lets you attack with sanity or knowledge, then you inflict mental damage.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sure.
Oh yeah. So the opponent uses the same trait. So we're both using sanity.
Cool. The astral spirits is pretty good.
Okay. Oh, that's a terrible roll from me. 4.
I got 7.
Okay.
What? Oh no.
So, the spirit takes no damage, but also I don't take any damage.
Okay. Cool.
I'm just floating. Woo! Spooky. Spooky Father Reinhardt.
spooky, spooky, spooky.
And then, while I'm here, I'm going to drink from my bottle, which I still have in ghost form.
Oh, you do, yeah.
Dun, dun, dun.
I'm going to roll 3 die, and we're going to see how it goes. Pow. That's a 3. I gain 1 knowledge and lose 1 might. That is fine. My knowledge goes up to 8.
Yo!
My might goes down to 2. that's so worth it.
Away?
Nope.
Can I assault your soul physically?
Yeah. Oh, it says discard item after use.
Oh yeah, true. No,
but
okay.
Does it not say in our spooky rules, does it not say you can no longer discard items or something?
I don't think so. I think it said you can't gain new items. You can use your items, but you can't trade or pick up new ones.
Yeah.
It was the trade bit I was misremembering then, thank you.
Okay. Well, there goes my bottle. Could have been better. Could have been worse.
That was, compared to some of the things that could have gone wrong, I think that was pretty good.
Yeah, that's the end of my turn.
Woo. Cool. So I think my physical body is still in play.
Yep.
Which means, does that mean I can I physically assault your soul with my sheer might?
Let me check.
Because that would be hilarious if I could. Ox Bellows is so strong, he can reach into the aether and force your soul into an arm wrestle.
Does it say, do you have any specific rules about attacking?
No.
Yeah.
It just says we can attack you,
but...
Mine doesn't. It just says my explorer is still in the game. But
yeah, I think you can attack us with physical damage and we take mental damage.
Sure.
There's a thing in our special attack rules, 0.3.
But he doesn't need to know that.
No, that's why I didn't say it, but... Yeah. Yes. but I'm wondering if it's only like spookies can only attack spookies and not...
No, like, if it doesn't say he can't attack us, then he can still attack us.
I have special attack rolls for my astral spirit, but not for my explorer.
Okay.
No, I think you're clear to attack my ghost if you want.
In that case, Father, test your might.
Except I can only defend with knowledge or sanity.
Oh, I see.
So I defend with knowledge, which is 8.
Nice.
Whee! 10.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, it says 8. Anything that would inflict physical damage to your soul inflicts mental damage instead. Yeah. So, yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Oh, nice. 8.
I defend.
Not nice.
Nice. Oh! Okay, cool.
Boom, boom.
And then my astral. It says. It doesn't say this explicitly.
So, actually. But,
Does my astral spirit have its own turn?
Yes, it goes after you.
Yeah.
Because you lost by 2, you take 2 mental damage.
Oh, wow, do I?
Jeez. Yes.
Okay.
I think you choose which mental damage to take, but yeah.
Sure, I think so, yeah.
Okay. Sure.
Although, actually, it's... Well, that's a special attack. I think this was a... It's confusing.
Yeah, is there not anything in the...
Because if it was a regular attack, then he'd take the difference in damage. But if it's a special attack, then he's stunned.
If you're defending. If you're defending, is that even an attack?
Yeah, I'm not making an attack, so it is defending, so you do take the 2 damage.
Sure.
Dun.
Okay, cool. And then my astral spirit.
Yeah.
It is going to...
I'll move my ghost off of it.
What is a special attack, though?
That's when we're attacking.
Oh, so you were just defending against...
I was defending against his regular attack, yeah.
Okay.
So... I am going to go 1, 2, 3.
But would your defense... How does your defense damage him? I thought your defense would just...
In regular attacks, if you make an attack against someone, they defend. Whoever's stronger deals damage to the other. That's standard attack mechanics.
Okay.
So it takes 2 movement to get out of a room with an opponent.
Okay, sure.
So it would be 2, 3.
So it'd be in here.
Yes. Let me just check.
Howdy.
Where's? Oh, I need the flytrap card still. Flytrap. Does your spirit have might?
No, it doesn't have any physical stats.
Okay,
except
then
for speed, so it can move.
Then I don't think the fly trap, my big tree thing, can hit it.
Yeah, it doesn't say. Let's have a look. Yeah, no.
It says any hero, traitor, or monster you may attempt a might 7 attack.
Yeah, but if it doesn't have might,
then
I can't attack.
Okay.
I guess that means it's incorporeal.
Yeah.
I guess, if it doesn't have might.
But we can attack it with our mental abilities.
But this is what I'm wondering. How can he attack us as spirits if, as spirits, we essentially only
Because he's a human and he has more abilities than a tree, I guess. The tree just has might attacks. Humans have
mental
attacks.
No, I don't mean
attacks.
The tree. I mean...
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Ox Bellows has mental abilities and therefore can make attacks. I mean, it's one of those things. It should say in the rules, but apparently it doesn't.
So he can't attack our spirit forms with physical attacks? Because then we couldn't contest them.
If that was the case, it should say in Trelawney's rules.
Yeah, and it doesn't.
But by that logic, if the tree man then can't attack the astral spirit because he doesn't have...
Well, I mean, standard attack rules are you can't attack something with might that doesn't have might. But the rules specifically said we still have our might and speed. We just don't use them. Does so, it say that? Yes.
No?
Where does it say that?
It says we still...
You retain all of your traits.
So we still have our might and speed.
Right.
But we just, when we defend, we don't do it with physical traits.
You're not affected by any room text that mentions...
Yeah, that's room, so that's different.
Yeah. Okay.
I think this seems like the way to play it, because otherwise it seems particularly harsh on Ox Bellows.
Yeah, yeah. I trust your prior knowledge, I'm just confused. And
yeah, yeah. It should be more clear in the rules, but it's not.
Cool. Thank you for explaining.
So that was the monster moved, did it?
Yeah, no, it can't do anything, I don't think, right now.
Okay.
So that's the end of its turn.
So, Zoe, you're...
Hello.
You're in a room with...
I am in a room.
Naughty monster.
With yes.
Naughty monster.
Now, I feel like there's extra mechanics when there's more than one person in a room. I could be wrong. I might be thinking of a different game, to be honest.
So, yeah, I want to attack the Astral Spirit, right?
Yes, I'm just checking if you get...
Okay.
Any... I think I'm thinking of a different game. Special attacks, blah, blah, blah. Da-da-da. No, I'm thinking of something else.
Okay. I am rolling 6 sanities.
And 5.
Did not roll super good. 5.
Astral Spirit. Defend yourself.
Okay, hang on. So, it's a... What check is it? It was a...
Sanity, please.
Got it. Sanity.
That is more numbers than mine.
You successfully defend.
Yeah, you rolled a 6 and I rolled a 5. Boom.
Do you take any damage or is that something special in your rulebook?
We do not take damage from defending.
Okay. If you attack the Astral Spirit and lose, you do not take any damage.
Okay, cool.
So you do have your
movement.
It would take 2 movement to get out of this room because there's an enemy in it.
Yeah. I think I will move.
Yes. I mean, it does appear that the spirit is moving in this direction towards a certain thing that I'd be interested to protect.
Yes. Yeah. So that's my 4 movement into the storm cellar.
I just want to shove my body into the vault and shut the door.
Yeah.
Although the spirit probably doesn't worry about doors, so that would...
I mean, we don't, so...
Yeah, that's true.
Yes, that is my turn endeth, I think.
Yeah. Nice. Jenny, would you also like to kick the ghost's ass?
Yes, I want to attack yon ghosty. I would like to use my bloodstone.
Ooh.
Let me lose 1 from any trait. I am going to lose...
Oh, that's for a trait roll. Attacks aren't trait rolls.
Say it again?
That's only for trait rolls, and attacks don't count as trait rolls, unfortunately.
Balls. Okay. Then I guess I will just roll... Let's try knowledge.
Yeah. I don't suppose it matters really because it's.
Well, it depends what his stats are.
What his naughty is.
Oh.
Oh yeah.
So, what do you want to roll with?
Knowledge.
Knowledge.
Oh, I rolled with knowledge.
Oh, no.
I rolled with sanity.
Oh, I rolled with knowledge.
Yeah.
I think he's both. They're both quite high. So.
I think they're the same. Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll have to start counting dice.
He's got 6.
Do you have 7 for the last one?
Well,
he seemed like he had more for sanity.
Yeah, I think he had 7 for sanity.
Oh, that's 4. Against three. Ah, five. Damn.
So that's nothing again on the spirit?
Yeah.
Yep.
We've got a will and attack.
Okay. In that case, I will move this way. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. No, wait. Yeah, no, I can go through walls.
Yes.
So, yeah, I'm there.
Mm-hmm. Nice. And then Professor's turn.
Oh, hang on. Did I not move enough?
No, you moved 1, 2.
I meant to. I thought I moved 4. Yeah, I counted wrong. Can I also go to where Andy is?
You can. Yeah.
Did you have to? Was it an extra movement because you were?
Yes. So that's 2, 3. You currently moved 3.
Yeah, this is 2.
Yeah, I thought I counted 1, 2, and then I counted 3 in the gym and 4 in the cellar because I counted 2 to leave the room.
Yeah, you've got one more then. Yeah.
But I counted wrong because I am good at math. Okay.
Mm-hmm. So I've got 6 speed.
Sorry, I can count.
So 1, 2,
blimey.
3.
Flipping heck.
Then I attack the spirit with knowledge again. Always knowledge. 8 knowledge. Sure.
That does seem to be the way to go.
Pow. 8.
Oh no, it's also 6. He rolls with 6 for both.
What did you get? Oh wow,
8.
That's a lot more than me. Yeah, yeah, I got 4.
So, let me check the thing.
Get him good.
But. So, it's the thing.
Just having a trivia
take
off.
A thing.
Yeah.
And put a knowledge token,
on yourself, I think? Or on him?
On each time a hero attack succeeds. Okay, yeah. I take it.
Yeah, it doesn't tell me how to track damage on the spirit.
Okay. So we track that. That's nice. Good.
Yeah.
There we go. I take a token. And then I've still got 3 more movement. So,
so
1, 2.
From our rules, am I reading that it's collectively achieved? It doesn't have to be you that collects.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
Da-da-da. And yeah, it's the number, not the total number.
Yep.
So that's the end of my turn. Back to Ox Bellows.
Naughty nice. Turn.
Ox Bellows has 3 movements, so he is going to move 1, 2,
attack.
3 into the gym.
The tree attacks you.
The tree. Yeah!
Yeah, Jeff!
Go, give
Jeff!
Us a whack.
The tree attacks you with a might of 7.
Oh, jeez.
Yes.
Go, Jeff. Oh, that's 2.
No, Jeff!
That is 7.
Okay,
you should have rolled the green dice for better tree luck.
I don't think the tree takes any damage, but it doesn't hit you.
Nice.
Yeah.
Bam.
And I don't think it counts as an enemy that it would slow you down.
Okay, cool.
Double down.
In that case,
it just takes a swipe and whiffs.
Yeah.
Nice. And then that's the end of Ox Bellows' turn. It's time for the naughty monster.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's gonna 1, 2, 3.
Okay. He can use Mystic Elevators. I think Discord's
dead.
No. Whatever the dice gets.
Bad.
Three. So that is upper floor. So which counts as an upper floor?
That's the main ground floor.
Okay.
Oh no, is it up a floor?
Upper. The upper floor. And it counts the roof as well, because the roof is in the expansion and the Mystic Elevator is from the regular game.
So it's either the upper, so it's the upper landing or the roof.
So
yeah.
Can I choose either?
Yes,
or?
Yeah.
Lovely.
What a surprise. That
okay.
is where you chose.
Yeah.
Good.
Oh, so surprising.
Jolly good.
You have your secret map there, Andy, so you're...
I do. I will give chase.
I think that is all the spirit can do for now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Spirits go.
Zoe.
Yeah, hi. So, where was the climbing up basement tree thing? Oh no, that was the next floor, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm just gonna go up the stairway then.
Yeah, you either go to the grand staircase or the secret stairs to the graveyard, which is just further away.
Do I have to do a sanity roll in the graveyard, despite the fact I'm a ghost?
No, but it's further away from where you're trying to get to anyway.
Yeah, up the stairs.
So one to the grand staircase, two to the upper landing, three gets you to the roof.
Yeah, sure. I'll
and then you can get into the mystic elevator as well if you want with four.
Ooh, yeah, sure, let's do that.
And then, hit it with your brain.
Can I both attack him and then move the elevator?
You can.
Cool. Okay, I'll try and smack him first and then move the elevator. Nice. Okay. Smacking him with
the downside of the mystic elevator, we can move you around.
Yes. I will sanity smack you.
Are you sanity smacking?
Yep.
Sure.
That's a six.
Yelling therapy slogans at him.
Yeah. Uh-oh, that looks like more than six.
Seven.
Oh!
Okay.
Oh, good.
But we can take him away.
Now I need to roll for the elevator.
Move him away from Jenny's body.
Two die for elevator?
Yes.
Okay. Come, dice that have had less chance to roll. Do not let me down. I've wasted far away. Elevator.
Two. The ground floor.
Ground floor.
Yes.
Nice.
Yes.
So you have to attach it to the treehouse because that's the only spot.
Bloop.
Nice.
Fabulous. Good work.
Yay.
Jenny.
I would like to.
You're four away from the naughty monster.
Yes, I would like to chase after yon naughty monster.
It's just ghosts floating around the house.
Yeah.
Through walls and doors. Just.
No wonder we can hear Ox like crying and laughing at the same time. He's like, ah! I'm the only one that can't go through walls. I'm sad now. Clicking noises. Only four?
Four. That's not too bad.
Is that contested?
Yeah.
Sanity, I assume?
Yeah.
Knowledge.
Knowledge.
Okay. Doesn't matter. Yeah, six.
Not sure why you're asking every time.
Nice.
Okay. You can roll for the elevator if you want, but it could move.
I think it's probably safest here.
Although, I mean, in theory, if it, you don't have to put it on the roof no matter where you roll, because if you go to the upper, you can put it on like the drawing room, and then it's still two away from the landing.
Yeah.
And if you get the basement, then you put it right back the other side of the catacombs again.
That was good.
So I think it's worth a try on the mystic elevator.
Okay. So how many do I roll?
Two dice.
Two.
Nice little stack.
Two. dice, please. There we go.
Cool.
Oops. Laying them off the table.
That's two.
Two.
Which is ground floor, so it there isn't anywhere else it can move to, so it just kind of stays where it is.
All right.
It kind of grumbles and goes, and then it's like, oh, no.
It's too heavy. The weight of these three ghosts stopping it from moving.
There's too much astral energy. We're over the limit.
Yeah. Father Ghost, with my six movement. One, two... Three, four, 5. I attack the monster with knowledge.
Elevator buddy!
Knowledge?
Oh my goodness, that lump of dice?
That's 8.
That's more than I got.
Yay!
Woo! Nice.
Knowledge saves lives and hurts bad things. And then I'm going to roll for the Mystic Elevator because it's fun.
Yay!
Whee.
It seems like such a good idea.
It's a 1. That's the basement.
Yay!
Oh, no.
We're all going to the basement.
No.
Back to the catacombs you go.
Oh, no.
Amazing. I end my turn.
Nice. Right. Big man is going to let's have a look. Big man can't do anything particularly useful where he is at the moment. You know what? He might just stay there in his inner sanctum, his safe place.
Okay. Gym. I like how you got the dog, which is useful for like moving items. But it's like, it has no use in this scenario at all.
Yeah, no one. So, I am going to use the elevator first.
Okay.
And try and get away from the catacombs.
Basement!
That's 1! Basement!
You can put it.
Go back to the dungeon.
You can put it on the dungeon. There we go. Yeah.
So, when you go to a. When you go to the landing, you have to spend a movement to exit the landing to travel to another landing.
Yes.
Query. So, when you enter the dungeon, must you attempt a sanity roll of...
I think I'll do one. Yeah. But I don't think I will. I think I'll happily share this elevator with you all. It's nice company, you know? I've been trapped in that amulet for, like...
It's also, years. For each opponent in a room... You must use an extra space of movement to leave the room.
Oh my goodness.
But it goes down to a minimum of 1. So you can get out of the elevator. You just can't
go any further. Sure, I was going to say, just locked me in the elevator.
Rob's standing in front of the door.
Yeah.
Right, okay, cool. I think that's the end of Spooky Ghost's turn.
Nice.
Amazing.
Well, we'll all just stay in the elevator and keep hitting the spirit.
Yep. I guess that's what I'm going to do then. I was like, hey, I've got my chalk item. Then I was like,
my astral spirit can attack you guys.
Yeah.
I didn't read that. Yeah. Okay, never mind.
Which one of us do you want to attack?
Yeah.
Good question. I think I'm going to attack... Father. Gotta go for the holy man first. Knock him out as soon as possible.
Sanity or knowledge?
That's a good question. give me a moment. Sanity for sure.
Yes. Figured. Yeah. 1 less.
Yeah. 9.
7.
Ouch.
So, how does that work? You take... 2 points of damage?
Yes, 2 points of mental damage. I might take it both insanity.
Damn.
Keep my knowledge at 8.
I like your glasses.
Yeah. My triangular shades. Perfect.
Nice. Alright, then it's the end of Spooky Ghost's turn.
Yeah.
Okay, now I'm going to roll dice at you.
Get him.
Sorry, I was eating chocolate. It's very cold, so it's not melting quick. I will roll 6 dice. I am sanitying you.
Okay.
Ooh! Oh, it's not
5.
As
good as
it.
6.
Oh. 6.
It almost, that last one, almost tipped.
Yeah. I don't know if it's worth trying to move the Mystic Elevator again. We'll probably just move him closer. Depends. It's like, what's the furthest point from all of us, I think, is like on the drawing room?
Yeah, because of the roly-roly dungeon.
Oh, the dungeon's pretty good, yeah.
Yeah, where we are is pretty good because even...
I mean, it's a sanity roll and he's got 6 dice, but... there's always a chance he uses.
Just spooking through. I feel like this probably is the best position, eh?
Yeah, leave it for now.
Yeah, either that or, like you said, the drawing room.
Hmm.
I can try it. I don't know. Because to get the upper level, I need to roll a 3. Well, I guess, yeah.
Now that I think about it, because he was nearer Father Reinhardt, maybe he has to do a roll against me to take over my body. And therefore, that's why he didn't go for me. He went for someone with lower stats.
Maybe.
So maybe.
Sure, let's stay here then.
Maybe we can stay here and he won't go for my body because it's too difficult to take over.
Sure. I guess he is going to move the elevator next time anyway, so yeah, sure. I will. That is me done. I'm just going to chill out and be like, haha.
Yeah, it's staying here, so if he leaves the elevator, he can only move one spot anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No matter where the elevator is.
Yes.
Jenny.
Tag. Jenny, you're it.
Hit him.
All right. Sorry.
Hit him with your brain.
I'm going to hit him with my brain. Whee!
Two!
Jeez.
Spooky ghost, defend yourself.
Okay. Sorry, I was just double checking something.
Okay.
I was just reading my secret
rules.
Yeah. Ooh. I keep not seeing one of your dice and thinking it's closer than it is.
So, does that succeed?
Yes, you defend.
Yes.
Cool.
But have you tried defending against 8 knowledge?
Yes, successfully previously.
Pow.
Such a ball of dice. Ooh.
10.
Ooh. That was good.
That's looking good.
Yeah.
5.
That's 5.
I doubled it. Yes, give me a third addition to my sunglasses. Make the Triforce.
That's the nuclear warning logo.
Yeah, that too. My brain is nuclear.
Nuclear priest.
Yeah.
Back to Ox Bellows.
Nice. Ox Bellows is going to move. 1, 2, 3.
Oh dear.
Uh oh.
And attack your defenseless body.
No!
No!
That hero can't defend against your attacks.
Yes.
So roll 2 dice and deal mental damage equal to what's rolled.
Yep.
Oh, I tried to make a Triforce of sanity rolls.
0.
Oh, no.
Hey.
Father Reinhardt cares not for your fists upon my unconscious body.
I should have been doing this a few turns ago, but I didn't read that part correctly.
Yes, you should.
Yes, we were aware of it, but we didn't want to let you know.
Yeah.
So I was like, the bullet point 3 thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ghost turn.
Nice, ghost turn. Ghost is going to go for the elevator.
Ghost in an elevator.
1, 0. 2, ground 2. Floor.
Ground floor.
Back to the treehouse.
Yep.
Nice, and then I'm going to... Naughty monster is going to get out.
Hooray.
The end.
You could have attacked one of us before you moved as well, if you want.
I will attack one of you before I move.
Just to be fair, to remind you.
Thank you. I will go for the father.
Okay.
Actually, you know what? No, I will reward your fairness, father.
Okay.
by going for someone else. Odds it's Bloomers, evens it's Andy. Andy!
You know there's double as many evens on the dice as there are odds.
Oh yeah, of course.
Because there's a 0.
it's okay. It's fine. If it's a 1 or a 2, if it's a 0, it's a reroll. It's
okay.
Fine. I got my answer anyway. Andy, I am going to roll. Good question. Sanity, please.
They're both four.
Have some of those.
Yeah.
Ah.
Oh.
I need to stop.
They'll come back. Don't worry.
That is a six. Yeah. Go, Andy. Nope. Six. Oh, hello.
I did not.
The game is saying there are zero.
I feel like that should be a reroll because they're literally levitating.
Go again.
Like, I believe it when it says they're a little bit cocked, but like, levitating dice feels a step too far.
Four.
So 2 points of damage.
Which must both go insanity, or can you choose?
They have to go to mental, so you can.
Okay, you can
choose
do one
mental
each.
Sanity. Yeah.
Well, I still get the same number of dice if I take one.
Yeah, one each.
Nice. And then Spooky Ghost enters the treehouse. how does the treehouse work? Like with climbing the plant?
It's one of.
It goes up to the.
Yeah, it's like up, it's the same as walking through a wall.
To the attic.
To the attic.
Yeah, so you don't need to climb the plant.
It's the attic.
Yeah,
So you just spend one movement and zoop, you're there.
Yep.
Yes, same as if you fall through the collapsed room and the staircase hole.
Yep. Cool. No worries at all. Right, that is Spooky Ghost's turn.
Zoe.
My go. I probably should chase the spooky ghost.
Yeah, we're just following it around the house.
Bye, spooky ghost. So
even if we can't kill it, it can only move one square a turn.
Let's chase.
I am gonna roll six dice at you for sanity.
Sure.
Uh oh.
Oh, that's a lot of twos. I got eight.
I got nine!
Hey, nice.
Nice.
So I get a sanity triangle.
Sanity thing.
Oh, thank you.
And that brings our total up to...
You've given her a little beard.
Four.
She doesn't want a little beard.
Which I believe...
Is that four now?
When the heroes have collected a number of those tokens equal to the number of players in the game, the Aspel Spirit is destroyed.
Nice.
And then we read the thing. Your companion sends a devastating psychic attack through the astral spirit. The air shimmers and you dissolve. When you awaken, your body feels strange to you, as if you got a bit too drunk at a party and wore someone else's coat home. But at least it's your body. You're sure it will fit again soon.
Yeah.
You're sure it will fit again soon.
Yay, good job.
Everybody wakes up.
Yay! My Victorian child friend will be very happy to see me.
I wake up in a room with Ox Bellows and I slap him.
Standing over you, like with his gutter pipe. Yeah.
You piss at him like an angry cat.
I go full exorcist mode and start flicking water in his eyes and holding
my
cross.
No,
please. No. The power of Father... Whatever your name is.
Reinhardt.
No, my gains! And you see Ox Bellows just shrivel down. Pre-gym Ox Bellows.
Nice. We did it! Yay!
Yay!
We got a bit lucky that it was a knowledge sanity based haunting.
Yeah, it was
haunting.
One of these things in this one where, so it's not a contested check for me to, so I had to try and possess one of your bodies.
Yeah.
And it's not a contested check. It's just, I just have to roll higher than whatever your starting sanity or sanity score is.
Oh. We knew that it was like we couldn't defend against the astral spirit attacking our physical bodies, which is why we were like, please do not go near our physical bodies.
Yeah. Well, I was trying to go for Andy's because I thought, well, the elevator will take me right there. And like, not only that, starting is like really low, I think.
Yeah, with both, both of the... Zoe and Jenny had three on one of their stats. Whereas my lowest is four.
Yeah, it's not the one I needed, though. I think it's, the starting one for Jenny is the lowest, which is four. I think
Can you use knowledge? Did you have to use sanity?
No, it has to be sanity.
Oh, okay.
It has to be the starting score of sanity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yeah, no, it was interesting. It was really, yeah, it was cool. I definitely feel a bit more comfortable doing that a second time if I had to play again. I understand. Mm.
Yeah, there's so much replayability of this game.
Yeah, 100 different. This is the haunt 49 out of 102.
Yeah. It's incredible. Like, because when I first heard it was like, oh, you have to like go to the scenario. I was like, oh, blimey, like that's you're buying a board game and like you're going to recognize ones that you've had before. But yeah, the chances of you getting the same one again and there's a lot.
Yeah, I mean, I have played the physical game with people and we've landed on something that we have done before, so we just pick a new omen and get a different one instead.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, that makes sense. I guess even then it might play out slightly differently if different items and stuff in the game.
Yeah, but depending on your characters and items and stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, like the Mystic Elevator, right, in this one, basically all kept us in one room.
Yeah, that was very lucky, I think. Had you had greater reign just to wander without us being able to track you,
I think
that would have been a lot more if
you've got an extra hit on me, maybe it would have been different. Although I probably wouldn't have I would have dropped my sanity down to like the lowest possible before taking any points out of knowledge.
Way
more useful.
Yeah, it helped that Dave was like so OP.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, you Dave's character.
Father Brain.
It was 8 and 7 to start with,
The Lord giveth.
It was, that starting character
overflows.
That starting character, plus the library, plus the study.
I was going to say, if the...
Plus the Amulet of Ages.
The Haunting before we'd got the study and library, that would have made a big difference, even without the Amulet.
Yeah, the spirit has pretty good stats. It's got, it's got 3 in speed and 6 in both sanity and knowledge.
Yeah.
So it's pretty good.
Yeah.
But yeah, basically, I had to win a check against your starting sanity score 4 times to possess your body.
Oh, okay. So it wasn't quite as instant as get there.
Oh, that's why you needed the 4. So you part against one person. Yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
Cool. Okay.
Nice.
So, yeah, nice. That was good.
Amazeballs. Yeah, that was sweet. Fun.
Yeah, that's a fun game.
Yeah. Well, I mean, if you'd be up for another game sometime, I'd definitely be.
Oh, definitely.
To play.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Even if it's not on stream, just you know, I love this game. I'll play anytime.
Yeah,
yeah, it's really fun.
Definitely, anytime.
Yeah, nice. And this is a good. Yeah. Someone's done a lot of work to.
They.
To
good,
do
they've
the
done
work.
Really good. Yeah.
Detect the when the omens that's... have picked up and things like that.
Yeah, if the only thing that's a tiny bit broken is the little circles, sometimes there's more than there should be. That like, yeah, that's very excellently done.
Nice. Fabulous. Well, thank you for being here, guys. This was a good one.
Yeah,
It's only a 3-hour stream, but I might call it there anyway. Have some good old spooky times, and then
okay.
Yeah, tomorrow is D&D. Come by. Enjoy stuff. Hopefully Sam and Lucy will be okay. They're a bit coldy still and losing their voices, so they might have to, or get them like a text-to-speech thing and they can just type out what they want to say.
We can use your Welsh man who does read.
Oh,
yes, they have to donate bits every single time they want to say something.
Do you have a name for him yet? Do you have a name for him? Can I nominate Bryn?
I think Stream Elements calls him Geraint.
Geraint or Geraint?
Geraint, yeah, I did used to know one in real life. We just called him G because it was easier.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Yeah.
I wonder if I can make Victorian Child have a light. I bet that won't work, but I'm going to try anyway.
Not once you've given yourself one. It takes some to do another one. But in theory, it does work with pretty much anything. We never really used those on stream because they were a little bit buggy. But nice. Well, we'll try and come back to this at some point. D&D tomorrow. Next week, Left 4 Dead and Town of Salem.
Oh, yes.
I might do some Little Nightmares as well because I picked that up after playing Bramble the other day. And then Sunday is the fabulous live event of... custom trivia murder party that I've been working on everybody's welcome to come and join in and potentially win. Sunday, right. It's going to be great. And then on Halloween itself, I'm doing a trick-or-treat stream with a whole bunch of tricks and treats that we're going to spin a wheel and see what it lands on for fun.
Right.
I might try and also put a pumpkin in the laser cutter and see how well that works.
I might fill
my apartment with the smell of burning pumpkin. We'll
burning
see.
Pumpkins.
Maybe,
yeah,
maybe nice. It'll be fine.
Amazing. Yeah, sounds good.
Great. Well, thanks to the mods for being here. You're all fabulous. Thanks to the viewers. You're all so wonderful. I very much like you all.
Feelings mutual. Spooky ghost, however.
Spooky ghost.
Naughty monster.
Yeah. Ooh, there's someone live who I've been meaning to raid for a bit. There's a YouTuber called Emma Thorne who makes
documentary videos literally today.
Oh, really?
I've heard that name.
Yeah,
she does critique videos of MLMs and conspiracy people and stuff like that. It's good fun videos.
Yeah,
but she also streams spooky stuff and things like that.
Amazing.
Oh, no.
So I'm going to drop her a raid.
Yeah, I was watching one of hers earlier about some, and I don't use this term lightly, slightly nutty gentleman who's somewhat of a religious zealot has been critiking her videos.
Ah,
yes.
Yeah, those are the best ones, which is just the back and forth with people.
Yeah.
Nice.
So go say hi, drop her a follow, enjoy her spooky game. She's playing Observation Duty, which is a fun one. Nice. But yeah, I'll hopefully see you tomorrow and next week. If not, have a wonderful weekend. Love you all. Bye, everybody. Bye. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.